I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like me. But time off from that emotion. Time to pick my heart up off the floor. Takes a song and baby, but I'm showing you that door. Rock, gotta have faith. Gotta have faith. Gotta have faith. Gotta have faith, baby. I know you're asking me to stay. Stay, please, please, don't go away. Cause you're giving me the blues. Baby, you might be all the words you say. Showing you that door, rock, gotta have faith. Gotta have faith. Gotta have faith. Gotta have faith. Get the fuck up.
motherfuckers. It's the Real Ass Podcast. It's your boy, Louis J. Gomez.
We're from Rattlesnake, Real Ass Dude, Ultimate Minority, Joined Jet of Comedy. I got a lot of names.
International superstar Zack and Amico.
How you doing, buddy?
He's funny. He's a psycho. He's a real ass dude.
I was double teaming this chick with her husband. Now he's selling coke in heaven.
Are you fucking ready, motherfuckers?
It's the only real podcast left out there.
Fucking. I'm hurtling over a guy who's dressed like a bisexual Michael Moore. That's nice.
Oh, shit. Tom Myers bringing the fucking heat.
Boom.
Eat it, Zack.
No, I'm not. I'm not going back against fire like that.
Yeah, you can't, dude. Are you kidding me? Can you give him a fucking guest attack? Because he fucking just smashed Zack to his fat face. It was awesome. Shannon. Fucking love it, dude. I like how you also don't even give a shit. You said, I don't even care that Zack's the co-host of the show. I'm going to smash him to his face. Love it, dude. Put the music
back on. Here's the thing. Here's the thing. I generally hate doing podcasts, but, you know, you were just so... You asked nicely if I could come on this podcast. You said, hey...
I sent him a dick pic.
Would you please get up here, motherfucker? That's what you said.
I did.
You said please, which is important.
We talked about doing it because I get so many requests for you. It's fucking crazy.
Right.
A lot of times, in the beginning, it was just you, different people pretending to be you, saying, hey, let me do your podcast, faggot. I want to fight you. And I was like, this guy's aggressive. Right. And I appreciated it at first.
Right. I never call people faggots.
Why not?
I call them morons. I call them gomers.
So okay. It's fucking crazy.
Right.
A lot of times, it was just you, different people pretending to be you, saying, hey, let me do your podcast, faggot. I want to fight you. And I was like, this guy's aggressive. Right. And I appreciated it at first.
Right. I never call people faggots.
Why not?
I call them morons. Okay. I call them gomers.
Okay.
You know,
Gomer.
The word faggot is too...
Gomer sounds... Gomer is much more insulting. I don't know what gomer means, but it seems like much more insulting than faggot. What is gomer?
Is it Gomer Pyle? Like a goofy guy who's not good at military
surprise,
activities?
Surprise, surprise,
surprise. I like that.
It's pretty much the mentality of most of the people who respond to me.
So that's what
on
it
Twitter.
Means? It means Gomer Pyle?
Right. It's a reference to Gomer.
Gomer. Fuck yeah, dude. We compare Harrington to Gomer Pyle all the time, so he's a gomer. Look, Gomer, an inept or stupid colleague, especially a trainee or a tranny.
Okay.
So you're anti-trans. You're anti the trans movement.
I'm anti-trainees.
Okay, well.
I'm a gomersexual. Why don't you like podcasts?
What's the problem with podcasts?
It's just one of those things where I go on and it's just like a one-shot deal, and then they bring me on, and then I get used to my surroundings.
Yeah, yes.
Pretty much. Yeah,
because you're not doing well.
I write for
same reason. Dating women. Yeah. It's not the fault of the medium. You know, it's not the medium's fault.
See, I write for a podcast, which I'll go ahead and plug when we do that appropriate segment. And
wait a minute.
The only reason that
you write for a podcast.
Wow. The only reason that
maybe this could be the audition for him to write for this podcast. I would
love
that.
You know what? Great.
The only kind of a gomer, I got to be honest with you.
I thought you had writers, Louis. Yeah. I thought you had a room.
I do.
They're all in his head.
Yeah. It's true.
But the only reason I think I'm still on this podcast is because
we haven't kicked you off after 4 minutes.
Right. Yeah. All right, everybody. See ya.
Wait, why? What do you think?
The reason I'm still on is because we all work from different cities. Like, I work from Maryland. Matt, the guy who runs the show, works from...
Can we turn the rap off, please?
No, he's a fucking killer.
No, I understand that, but I mean...
What do you have against...
about...
The whole show is going to be hard hip-hop.
Is the whole show just going to have hip-hop?
Hard hip-hop behind time Tom talks.
But it takes away from him.
What do you have against rap music?
Yeah, we have against rap.
Does black people do it?
Yeah.
I mean, that's the only thing.
Yeah.
I just want more whites.
I agree. Eminem's the best at it, though, and this is an Eminem song. So,
right.
And you love M&M's.
I want to hear it. I do. I do like an M&M.
I was actually
peanut butter cup is better.
Paying homage to you, Tim Dillon. I also recently learned the entirety of Rap God by M&M.
Okay.
Because I was supposed to challenge
Justin
Silver.
I want to hear Tom without, you know,
hip hop music behind
without
him.
Without a super successful person.
Let me see if he's as hardcore though without the hip hop
music.
That's
true.
It's so if you ever listen to like a fucking movie soundtrack without like the sound effects and all like
you're,
crazy
you're,
shit.
We might need it. You're right.
Tom, go. What were you saying?
I was saying that the reason I'm still on
put
this
it back.
Podcast,
I apologize. Put it back and turn it up. Turn it up. I was wrong.
Yeah, boy. There we go. No, don't really. All right, take it off, Shannon. Good.
It's like getting a lecture and there's like an MMA class right next door.
So you're saying the people on the internet, you call them gomers.
Right. Well, only the stupid ones, which being the internet is.
There's a lot of them. Do you deal with a lot of trolling, right?
Well, I think part of it's my fault because I kind of invite it. Right. I think it's because I think this is my personality. My personality is that of a troll, and that it attracts.
I think everyone's a troll. I think if you've ever gone online and been like, "Oh, this week's episode of Game of Thrones sucks," it's the same shit. Somebody wrote that episode. You know, there's a fucking lighting guy. You're trashing his job, you know, so that's sort of everybody. So I understand what you're saying. I want to look, we got to get into this. It's going to be a great show today. And we, you know, obviously, you know, we have to respond to the shots fired across the bow by CumTown for the past 2 or 3 years. I don't even know.
I don't really know. I'm not too
familiar. What happened either. All I know is that I think they've gone after our boy Tommy here, and
they've maligned him.
I don't even like those guys.
They've maligned him.
They were supposed to be on Skankfest. They pulled out of Skankfest.
Right.
Fucking last minute. They have
a tour in Canada.
They got a Canadian. That's fine. But who fucking cares about Canada, right? Okay. It's sort of the worst country. Everyone knows that. Okay.
Donald Trump says so. So it has to be true.
Fuck yeah, Tom. Hell yeah, dude. So we got to go. We got to figure out what happened there. And you got to go back because this is your opportunity. This is going to be. Now, look, we are maybe 1/8 the size of CumTown on the Real Ass Podcast.
Right.
This isn't Legion of Skanks.
We're actually 15 times the size of CumTown if you include me and Zack.
That's actually true.
Actually, you know.
But this is the biggest platform you'll probably ever be on, Tom. So this is your opportunity to really fucking give it to him, and I like that. So we're going to get into that today on the show. A lot of other things to talk about via the news and social issues. Tim Dillon, my brother, is here. Yeah. How long are you in town for until you're out in L.A.
June
for good?
June 1st.
You're done in two weeks.
But I'll be back a lot.
I know. You're going to do that shit. You're going to be telling everyone in L.A., I got to go out to New York.
Yeah. Well, I got to get out of here. Yeah. You know, New York is a city for... You know, the poor and the ugly.
Yeah.
We're going to be here for the rest of our lives, Lewis.
Have you been to Baltimore?
Well, no. Baltimore's a city for the damned. I mean, that's
Baltimore, I believe, was on a list as one of the ugliest cities in the world. Tom,
great crab.
And that's
cakes,
just.
A,
and that's
great
just,
crab dip, crab cakes.
Tom, you're one of the most handsome
great
people
heroin.
I've ever seen from Baltimore. You're actually.
Yeah, Tom, you were the top 10% of people in Baltimore in terms of looks.
Tom's a Baltimore 9,
which is. That's
Tom
that, that's
looks
bad.
Like a twink. He looks like a Make-A-Wish kid who never died. Like a kid who just hung
older,
on. He just hung on.
Wasn't this kid supposed to be dead years ago? I donated $50 to his GoFundMe.
He just somehow made it.
Tim, did I tell you that I...
This
I
was my Make-A-Wish when I was 15 to be on this podcast.
Well,
actually.
Thank you
that's
very much.
I'm
glad
here.
We can actually do something for somebody at one point. There was a child that I donated money to, and I felt bad.
James.
And then the mom, this kid's dying of some disease, and the mom kept on emailing me, being like,
you told me this.
But then...
What did you decide to do?
Well, I ended up blocking her.
Yeah, of course. I
didn't realize that she would... Yeah. She didn't know. But then they started hitting me up through the actual thing, so now I just unsubscribed from it.
Yeah.
So now, if they figure out another way to hit me up, I'm going to be wishing death upon this child.
Yeah, it's too much.
Yeah, I mean, at one point, I can't deal with it anymore.
Yeah,
it's not
too
my
much.
Problem.
I've strongly come out against GoFundMe.
Yeah, you can't do it. You can't donate.
And it's not like there's a way to find you or anything.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Let's get them plugs out of the way.
Yeah.
And we're going to really crush this show today. Tim Dillon, what do you have to plug, my friend?
Laugh Boston this weekend. Tim Dillon's going to hell podcast, timdillancomedy.com for live dates there. Mohegan Sun, Skankfest, American Comedy Co. in San Diego, blah, blah, blah. But just Tim Dillon's going to hell. Subscribe to that.
Hanging out in Joe Rogan's flotation tank.
Yeah, the sensory deprivation tank. Hopefully.
Going on a hike.
Hopefully soon.
Maybe.
I'm going to, in 6 months, my goal in L.A. is to lose 50 pounds, have an audience, and no longer be funny. And that's what
it's
going to
happen. Guaranteed. Nearly goddamn guaranteed.
It's not all it's cracked up to be.
I'll do
me.
It. Yeah.
Tom Myers, what do you got to plug, my brother?
My website, tommyers.us, TOMMYERS.US.
Tommyers.us.
My Instagram, YouTube channel, Facebook, and Twitter links are all on there. You can also check out Politipod, which is a podcast I write and perform a series of one-liners and sketches. New episode comes out next week, ipmnation.com/live2, Wednesdays at 9.
A lot of
Eastern
difficult
time.
URLs, Tom.
You're all over the place.
Yeah, the URLs are fucking crazy, doggy. What happened to TomMyers.com? Somebody else has that? What does that guy do?
I think it's just like a Japanese merchandise site or something.
You should send people there.
You should probably get involved with them.
That's fucking great. They sound like they have a fucking song. Like
they do have more hits than me, which is sad.
Guaranteed.
It is the saddest thing ever.
Zack Amico. There we go. Look, TomMyers.com is for sale. $1,485, Tom.
All right.
That's or $99 a month.
$99 a month, you can own that right now,
Tom. It's a bit high.
$99 a month is not bad.
$99 a month. Great. So TomMyers.com. All I need is to raise $1,484.50 more.
Go fund me.
And I can buy that site.
Go fund me.
Tom, yeah, 50 cents you're saying. Fuck yeah. So
don't do math jokes for Lewis.
Zach, no, dude, I can do math. Fuck off, dude. That was a fucking test. And Tom's testing me because he's the fucking alpha in the room, and I understand that. And it's all good. I like being tested. Test me anytime. Math-wise, yeah, throw it out there, Tom. Go up the show if you want to throw me any
six
math problem.
6 times 7.
36 plus 7 is 43.
Is it 43?
Yes, you got it.
I think it's 42.
Nope.
You got it.
6 times 7, I think, is 42.
Nope.
You got it.
Okay.
Thanks, Tom.
Maybe he is right. I don't know. I don't like meth either.
Thanks.
I can't tell you if you're right. I'm just very confident.
Zach, what do you have to plug, my brother?
Twitter and Instagram. Zach is not funny. And check out my other show here on the network, Zach Amico's Midnight Spook Show, every Friday at midnight. Comics sitting down and bullshitting while we watch a horror movie.
Hell yeah. Louis J. Gomez is Louis J. Gomez, the last comedy special ever. Fucking DePaulo could have done it if he didn't go and fucking flip off Mumia Mumbadoo Bajal.
Well, he did it. I mean, he's getting a lot of views.
Dude, whatever, man. I don't respect it, dude. You disrespect the Black Lives Matter activists.
They demonetize. He didn't know.
What are you going to do?
He had
over.
No idea.
He went too far. I say he went too far. Okay, so that's why you should buy Louis
J. Gomez. They
you know who didn't go too far?
YouTube.
You know who went just far enough?
Yeah.
Louis J. Gomez. Louis J. Gomez presents LouisJGomez.com.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. It's a good point.
What am I going to do?
Yeah.
Skankfest is sold out. You can go to infinitecbd.com/skankfest to try to win tickets. That's the only way you can get tickets. Well, you know, I'm going to give Tom Myers a pair of fucking Skankfest tickets.
Well, he's coming, right? Isn't he? He's on them.
I need a napkin.
I'm checking IDs at Skankfest.
Tom, actually. Would you do Skankfest? I saw you also submitted a 13 or 14 times.
Yeah.
Did you submit more than once?
Yeah, he did submit like 14 or 15 times, maybe.
I appreciate that.
Well, only about 11 or 12.
Did you really submit? So wait a minute. Do you just email again with the...
It's over and over again. Different videos.
Different videos.
Sometimes complimentary, sometimes...
Really?
Different email addresses.
I respect
that. For everybody who says it's me submitting for Skankfest, I give them a free CD.
Oh.
So, you know, I'm
good
like that.
Oh, so you have
that.
Other people doing the work for you. You're like a joker. It's like people in clown faces. I like this.
I have minions.
Okay.
So, yeah, 14 or 15 submissions. So, you really want to do Skankfest. Would you come and do it? Because now that CumTown's not there, I feel like now we don't have to worry about the weird tension. You don't want to book people that have.
Now, I don't
want to
see you and Adam Friedland fight.
Yes.
I don't want to see that.
And I know what you're thinking
honest,
right now,
do
Tom.
You don't want to see me cowering in a corner crying because
Adam Friedland makes you cower in
Tom,
a corner.
Tom, I know what you're thinking right now.
He's
Who's
just
Adam Friedland?
Boy.
He's one of the members of CumTown.
He's the female. He's the only female. On
one of the members of what?
He's very tiny. CumTown.
Yeah.
Do you not say? You don't even acknowledge CumTown.
One of the members of what?
He doesn't even acknowledge them.
That's cool. That's
that was bad. That was bad. Not badass. That was just
no.
Bad.
It's bad.
That was
I like it.
Joke.
Like bad, like Michael Jackson, like that song.
What?
No,
what
like bad
the,
as in an overtime.
What is
it's
the
an
start
overused...
of this war, Tom? Take because
what
I don't
happened?
Really know.
Why don't what did?
Lewis is a peaceful man. Lewis doesn't really get involved in drama.
I don't like drama.
So
I'm not into that. So
for
why
us, it's like we don't all
those. All those videos of him getting into fights are just Louis J. Gomez impersonators.
Those people were disrespecting you, and actually, I got your back.
His
all of those
MMA
people.
Fight he did was choreographed. It was like a dance. It was pretty gay. I watched. I saw them.
We're
do
trying
it.
To do like a new age,
right?
West Side Story.
Yeah, it was dance fighting.
Yeah.
So what happened with?
What's the beginning of the
genesis,
beef?
The origin story.
I think. Yeah, I don't even know because I'm so selfish that I just focus on myself, and
that's
I
good.
Honestly don't give a rat's ass about other podcasts or other performances. But
there's got to be a beginning to this. What was the very first time where you were like, Nick Mullen has it out for me? What was it?
I don't necessarily think he has it out for me. I recalled meeting him. God, this is years ago. We were both doing comedy in DC. At that time, I was
Washington.
Yeah, Washington. Well, the Baltimore, Washington area.
Got it.
The circuit.
Yep. Which I think Baltimore and Washington together, I think, is dwarfed by the New York comedy scene.
Yeah, I would
much.
Say. I would actually. I would agree with you and say that New York.
It's dwarfed.
It's actually a bigger and more vibrant scene than Baltimore.
The greater
Washington.
It is dwarfed.
DC
correct.
Comedies.
It is dwarfed by the Punxsutawney comedy scene. That's how small it is.
Oh shit!
Dropping truth bombs.
Okay, so you and Nick.
The truth.
you and Nick are both killers on the scene, coming up, getting some
Well,
attention.
I was already a touring road comic at the time.
You were already out there. So Nick was a young buck coming up. You were already fucking headlining, crushing it, doing your thing.
Oh,
Nick
yeah.
comes up
touring...
and
HBO, BET, Showtime, all that good stuff.
Were you touring, was it regional, or was it like, were you all over? Where were you touring?
Up and down the East Coast at that okay. time. I think I'd already performed in like a dozen states okay. at that point.
Okay.
So yeah, I was getting not regular work, but you know, just enough that you know, I was able to be a reasonably established comic at that okay. point.
So you're established. Here comes Nick Mullen. Lazy, right? What are your first impressions of him? Give me some first impressions.
Pretty much
just getting by on his looks.
Yeah.
Now that's funny.
Yeah.
But no.
First thing you see, this guy come in. You know, is he Jack Diesel at the time? Because he's all fucking Jack now, doggy. Does that intimidate you? It does, right?
No, it's just, nobody in the DC comedy community at that time really thought he was anything good at that time.
Oh,
they still don't.
Shit!
They still don't. He
still
literally
don't.
Only has.
Oh,
still
shit!
Don't. They still don't.
Wow.
Like, there are probably still, like, there are more.
Are any of them,
there
are
more
any
people,
them curious about,
there
like,
are more,
the 80 grand a month he makes?
There are more people in the studio of CumTown than there are DC comics who like Nick Mullen.
Oh.
So
that's three. So.
Oh, shit! So wow. You're saying in DC he's known as a fucking
right.
piece of shit.
I think he was in Austin, Texas for a little bit.
Okay,
and
we know.
I think even he got run out. Even he got. And Austin's a pretty chill, pretty laid back city.
Wow.
I mean, you have to be a big douchebag if even the people of Austin say, fuck off.
Yeah.
Wow.
So he was run out of DC and then Austin.
Right.
He gets run out of DC. Then he went
and
to Austin.
And then his punishment was right. to live in New York, this hell.
Yeah.
So, hey, if Nick DiPaolo says New York's hell, then it has to be hell.
I don't think Nick means that.
Yeah.
No.
Nick DiPaolo, I think he's...
He's just kidding.
I think he's just joking.
So, okay, so
I
you're...
Think flipping like... off Black Lives Matter people, talking about how New York is a hell, it's all an act.
Yeah. So you see this kid, Nick Mullen, you're a fucking... You're
an established road guy.
You're established.
And you have this young guy, and you're like, do you take on a mentorship role? Do you see him as like a little brother?
Because nobody else likes him.
Really.
People are probably
never...
in your ear being like, don't even hang out with this guy. This guy's a scrub.
There's nothing about him. You don't ever look at his act and say, let me help you. Let me give you a tag. Let me.
No, like any typical comic, I am selfish and only think of myself. So
okay.
That's,
well, in New York, there is
problem, yeah.
People try to help each other. People try to mentor each other.
Yeah, but okay, that's so why you're leaving. Those are losers, Tim.
I agree.
Yeah, you don't want to fucking...
That's why I haven't left Maryland.
But
that's
I mean
why.
This. If anybody comes up to me and they want to help me,
yeah,
I don't believe it, okay? There's this whole concept of being a good
I've
person.
I've tried to offer Adam Friedland help a lot. I've said, come to my apartment right at night.
Yeah.
Right late at night.
Go
let's
to sleep.
Let's do exercises together
yeah.
to get
nice,
all of it. And
do Pilates.
And again, nothing. So
you know,
we'd
probably
get
Adam Friedland.
Yeah.
If you fucked Tom Myers in the guest digital bathroom, it would probably make him... That's the ultimate alpha move. If you want to fucking...
That is an alpha... Let me tell you right now. An alpha move is to have sex with me in the gas digital bathroom to make Adam Friedland jealous.
How fucking funny would that be?
You got to buy me a drink first before you do that. And I'm a recovering alcoholic, so...
Oh, boy. Okay.
Ain't no way that's happening.
Oh, you're a recovering alcoholic?
Yep. Seven and a half years.
Seven and a half years. I tried to get you high before the show, and I asked you, I was like, do you smoke? And what was your response to me?
You said I
smoke a cigar once or twice a year.
Okay.
Right.
To celebrate. Celebration.
What is that? Is that the Stavros?
Is that the Stavros laugh?
Come on.
Come on.
Come on now.
So,
no,
I quit
smoking when I was 22, quit drinking when I was 28.
Congrats.
And
how old are you now? 50?
72.
Healthy.
36.
So do you okay. and Nick ever have any kind of friendship?
Not really, no.
Okay.
You don't know this guy.
I mean, I know him. In fact, I recorded a CD in Maryland years ago. I think I've actually blocked it out of my mind.
You don't remember the name of your album?
I think it was...
You don't want people to find it. That's what it is.
That's right. Okay.
I've sold enough copies.
I've done a lot of things I'm ashamed of. Sesame Street, I'm kidding. I'm not ashamed. It's on YouTube.
Loves it.
It's on YouTube. I produced a polka with Snuffleupagus. And
Meghan McCain?
And Meghan McCain, yeah, I know.
That's killing it.
It is.
So, but I'm recording this CD, and Nick Mullen is one of the comics on the bill.
Words of Mass Destruction.
Was that it? Not that one. It was Pitchforks, Torches, and Other
Random
Thoughts.
At least you use a really high-quality photo for that.
Right.
For that.
Pitchforks, Torches, hold on. What
Pitchforks, Torches, and Other Random Thoughts is the name of the...
Pitchforks, Torches, and Other Random Thoughts.
Right.
Okay. Wild. Okay.
I like it. All right, so you record the CD.
I record the CD, and Nick Mullen is one of the comics on the bill for the show.
Okay, all right, so he's opening up for you. This guy is your opener.
No. He's one of the comics who
well, you're
goes
closing
up
the
before.
Show.
He's so you, one you of the comics who goes
him,
up.
So, but you had no problem with him being on the show. I mean, it's your album recording.
Well, it wasn't the show wasn't booked by me.
Gotcha.
Like, it wasn't arranged.
Gotcha.
By me, it was arranged right. by someone else. So I just went ahead and performed.
And was
recorded.
It D.C.? You're doing this in Maryland.
In Maryland.
And you're doing an hour, and everyone else is doing like showcase sets.
Pretty much.
Okay.
So Nick is your opener. For all intents and purposes, Nick's your opener.
One of them.
Nice, dude.
So Nick, okay. So were you not a fan of a set, or were you like it's okay?
Well, he comes up to me. He comes up to me during as I'm getting ready to do my set because you've recorded a special and you're doing whatever you got to do to go ahead and make sure the set comes out right.
I would have never let somebody with a reputation like Nick Mullen at the time open up for me. He's been run out of Austin.
Louis Farrakhan opened for Louis.
I had the crying had Nazi. The yeah. crying Nazi did a tight 15.
He had a better 15 than Nick Mullen, the crying Nazi.
Yeah, man. Ease up. Ease
Shots
up.
Shots fired.
Shots fucking fired. So, Tommy, he opens up for you. What happens? Take us back here.
What venue is it in? We're all trying to picture this.
The venue is called Sean Boland's. It's an Irish pub. They do live shows there every once in a while.
Sounds
and
magical.
It was
sounds the bit like the best place to record it.
Robin Williams did an album.
Sounds like a fun.
You go there, you get drunk, and I sound funny. Sean Boland's
live at Sean Boland's.
Listen, I'm embracing my Irish ancestry
Nothing
by doing
wrong
that.
With that.
So.
Go see the ferryman.
DC or Baltimore.
It's in Bel Air, Maryland, not too far from where
Bel Air, Maryland.
Bel Air, Maryland. Sean Boland's in Bel Air, Maryland.
Bel Air, Maryland. It's produced some great.
I love
folks.
That Maryland just steals the name of other nicer places. Like, come down to Malibu, Maryland.
Yes,
Bel Air, Maryland.
There's a town.
There's no Bel Air, Maryland. Not on fire in 3 weeks.
Nightmare. There's a California, Maryland. Also,
I'm sure
it's in
there
the
is.
Southern part of the state. And
fucking
it's,
shysters. It's Maryland's also, a bunch of shady motherfuckers.
Takes, yeah.
I appreciate it though.
I appreciate
I give them a little bit of respect.
Yeah,
it's also a shithole. So.
Yeah.
But
you're at Sean Boland's, this packed out fucking place.
And Nick comes up to me and says and asks if he wants to get a drink and asks if I can put it on my comics tab.
And this is what year?
2013, I think.
Okay.
So this is, I think he had just come back from Austin.
6 years ago, just come back from Austin. He's like, hey, can I get a drink? Can you buy me a drink?
Right.
Essentially, buy me a drink.
Right. And I essentially
tell
him.
I'm not a fag.
I essentially
first
tell
thing you
him,
said was I'm not a fag, so I'm not buying another man a drink, right?
It's like you're in the room.
I know.
Louis. It's like
I
you're
know
in the room.
In
you
head,
know
dog.
What's
yeah, we're the same guy. I get it.
Mm-hmm.
So what happens?
I tell him, you know, I basically tell him no, and I don't have a comics tab, just because it's not exactly Sean Boland's isn't exactly a high class. It's not a high
wait
class
a
joint. It's not
Hold
a real comic.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
Bel Air.
Are
Maryland.
You telling me that Sean Boland's?
Yeah, imagine
Bel Air,
that.
Maryland. Is not exactly,
oh,
in your words,
no.
a high-class establishment.
Oh, fuck no. I mean, look at
Why
that.
Why did you decide to record an album at Sean Boland's?
Ambiance.
Ambiance, just despair, lost hopes and dreams. Nobody ever goes there, has anything
to
celebrate.
What was the idea? Because you're established at this point. You're like, is it almost like the way that Dice did his album at like, it was like an empty danger field.
Yeah, that's exactly what it
was
is.
That what was
it's
going
exactly
on?
The way Dice did it.
Are you a character? You're not like, are you not this badass of a dude? It's like a character you're putting on. Are you like really a, like a nerd on the inside and you fucking are pretending to be this fucking hardcore
no, I'm
motherfucker?
Just, I'm just a person where I just hate people in general.
Okay, I like
so
it.
Of course I have I do a I have a job where I talk in front of groups of people. So that's
what, is that?
What do you do?
Don't you get a drop for that? Don't you get your...
No.
No,
we
just,
that's
our good. Job.
It was too good.
No, we don't pour out things. So you, is this where it started? Nick says, "Buy me a drink." You said, "I don't have a comic."
I don't have a comic staff.
I don't have a comic staff.
How about you blow? You just pull this dick out. He's like, "You know what to do."
This isn't the DC improv.
Right?
No, it's not. This is Sean Boland.
So you pull out your cock. You're like, "Start sucking, bitch." And he, what
again,
does he do? Does he suck
like
it?
You, it's like you were in the room.
No, what'd you really
and he
do?
Just he goes off on me and says, "Yes, you do. You have a comics tab." And he just literally starts cursing me out. And
now let's be honest. This is just between us. Did you have a comics tab? Be
honest.
No, I didn't.
Really?
I did not.
Sean, still be there. Stop recording for a second.
Sean, can we call Sean Boland?
Stop recording for a second. Boland. We're not recording right now. Yeah. Did you have a comics tab?
No.
All right, start recording again. I believe you. I believe you. So he starts yelling at you, and at this point, what do? Do you have him ejected? You're the headliner. If my opener starts screaming in my face,
right?
Okay, I would say, hey, you
my
have
opener
to go.
Is fiending for some booze.
Yeah, obviously on right. fucking blow.
Right.
Coked out of his fucking mind. So steroids likely.
Yeah. That's someone that his mom probably bought for him.
Oh,
whoa! Where would she know how to get steroids, though? Let's be honest. Moms don't know where to get steroids.
Yeah.
I think he just works out. I don't think he does, but I don't know.
You brought his mom into it, too. That's fucking... You don't like That's this wild. Guy. That's some crazy shit. Right
I
there.
Don't do steroids. I want to clear that up because I am accused of all manner
wait,
of
wait
things.
Until the HIV really takes over. You're going to need them.
Yeah, I have defeated the HIV.
Oh, cheers.
The doctors will be like... The HIV has left the body. So, Tom, we're at Sean Boland's. We're in Bel Air, Maryland. Nick Mullen has asked you to buy him a drink.
It's 6 years
declined,
ago.
As is your
And this
right.
is also 6 years ago. This is before Nick Mullen
this
really
is
had
2013.
Anything going on. Nothing
he's
got, going on.
He's a young guy. He looks
so
at
yesterday.
You, looks up to you, maybe. He says you
likely looks up to you. You're likely, a fucking, you're the local
an album
guy.
At Sean Boland's. At that point, you say no, and you guys get into an argument, and is that it? Does he leave? Is that how you leave it?
I literally tell him to fuck off, because like I said, you've recorded a special
before,
and you want to focus, you want to make sure everything is going right.
Of course.
And I'm thinking to myself, I don't
you can't
need
deal
this
with
bullshit.
The drama.
I don't need this bullshit.
You don't need it. You just want to go up there. How long are you doing?
45. I think
I'm ready. There's a Yankees game on
right.
at the bar.
There's three other bar fights.
Yeah, you're going to deal with fucking
it's
all you
Sean
can eat wings from 7 to 8 p.m.
Right.
Yeah.
You were probably
arguing with
there,
the lighting too.
So you got to do a special. You're also bar backing. It's very difficult.
I'm trying to do like 15 different jobs
done.
Here.
Yeah, of course. How did the set go?
Went great.
Great.
But was Nick gone? Did you kick him out, or you said fuck off, and then he just watched and crossed his arms
and pouted
and pouted?
Yep.
Wow. And this is where the seed was planted. In this moment. This is where the seed was planted.
This is the origin story. This is the Marvel movie.
This is where Nick Mullen,
he has it out for you.
This is like, you know, Batman's parents being killed. You killed Nick Mullen's parents, proverbially.
Proverbially.
You said it right.
You said it right.
I got it.
You got it, yeah.
It took a lot of energy. Like, I feel weak.
Yeah. You are a lot smarter than me.
Thank
Lewis.
You.
You
I appreciate
are.
That.
You're better at math than me. You are better at speaking than me.
This motherfucker, don't you? Real ass dude of the week. Fucking Tom Myers. Give
Tom
it to
Myers.
Him. Fuck it. What am I going to do?
He's good. Yeah. He's a real ass dude. He's got bad attitude. He recorded his album with Sean Boland in Bel Air, Maryland.
None of that's true. You're smarter than me. You're funnier than me. You're stronger than me. But you will say that to me because that's some real alpha shit.
Yeah.
You'll just fucking say it.
Because
so
he doesn't have anything to prove.
Nothing to prove. It's a shark amongst.
Guppies. I just don't have anything.
So
I'll
that,
be
did you ever
you.
See him again after that moment, or was it just that was it? So did you just like see him? Like did you see him in the scene? I guess you would
no.
see if you bump into each other.
No.
So then
never. It's you never,
never
saw him again.
Well, he's up in New York, and I'm in Baltimore.
Right.
Yeah. Well, so, I mean, you're everywhere. You're headlining. You know, you're on the road. A little different.
I'm on the road.
Well, there's two different lifestyles. You could be a fucking road dog
road.
Like Tommy,
right.
or you could be a fucking New
but,
York
not,
open micer.
Whatever.
Like the CumTown boys.
You know? I'm not headlining.
You're not headlining?
No.
What happened? You just said you take a back seat, let the Young Bucks get a little bit of the meat?
Believe it or not, I'm not really traveling or performing live or doing anything like that at the moment. I'm focusing on
the
podcast. I'm focusing on Politipod.
Because politics is where it's at right now. Everybody is making a lot of money.
We don't talk politics on the show.
We don't really talk politics, and this is not an invitation to start.
No, here's the problem, though. Can I tell you?
Yeah.
We do a segment on the show where I give him the show for a minute. We treat it like his show.
Oh, okay.
But we don't talk politics. We have to be the guests, but we'll figure that out.
Now, how long have you been doing the Politipod?
The first episode went out in January of 2016. So okay. just in time for just in
so
time
exactly
for the election.
37 months after Nick Mullen fucking got into your
head.
Psyche.
36 and a half, give or take. But again, you are great at
who
math and figuring
won
out
that exchange. Because you said suck my dick. He said, "What the fuck do you?" Because I hear it and I think that Nick looks bad there. Nick's asking for a free drink, then getting mad that you're not just buying him a drink, and you say, "Yeah, dude, suck my dick. You're opening for me right now. I'm headlining my album taping." I feel like Nick looks bad here.
Well, he's in New York now, doing all sorts of big thing, and so he's
are you doing a football thing there. What was that?
That was like a Southern Baptist when you testify.
Okay.
He's in New York now.
He was double Heiling Hitler.
Wait a minute. Just
the one cancels out the other.
Tom, you did a black scent.
There's only one reason they put their hands up like
Tom,
that.
Tom, this is a woke show, and you just did a black scent, so I don't know.
Yeah, it's not cool, Tom. Not cool. But, all right, so what? You do your album.
I'd say it ended up being a draw.
It was a draw there, okay? Yeah. But yeah. Nick Mullen obviously harbors resentment because years later he goes on a podcast. What's the next moment that you heard about Nick Mullen or that you were drawn to Nick Mullen's life? Was it the podcast? He started talking shit on you? What was that?
Probably. Again, he's not in the on the list of things that I worry about. He's probably like below the trash service that I pick out, like below which trash service.
Oh shit!
Wait a minute. Why do you worry about the trash service?
And I don't.
Why do you have private trash collection?
How does this work?
You have private trash collection. This nigga's fucking crushing it.
It's crazy.
I can be used.
That's the name of his next album. He's doing the Sean Bullets. This Tom Myers. This nigga's crushing it.
This nigga's crushing it.
When they, I think they joke around maybe about you. Is it? Do you ever say to yourself, "We're comics"? People say bad things about me all the time that aren't true. People say that I'm loud, that I'm fat. There's all kinds of lies out there.
Can you do me a favor? Stop moving away from Tim slowly. I see he's making you uncomfortable. he's going out of frame slowly. Are you watching this?
Excuse me.
But do you ever just go, it's probably just people having fun and maybe it's not, you know.
I'll be honest with you.
Yeah.
I just don't really think about it that often.
Interesting.
That doesn't really concern me.
Some of their criticisms, I think, are the names of the things. Like one of the albums you have is called Make America Innate Again.
Right.
Now that name, and I've never heard the album, it could be very funny, but the name, and we can all agree, is retarded. Like the name Make America Innate Again is just it's an unfortunately named thing.
Well, it's a comedy CD, so it's not supposed to be something serious though.
No, of course. Now I've done things I regret, a lot of them. And I've named, but the name itself is just a little, like if you look back at that, would you have named it something else? Because just the name itself, it doesn't roll off the tongue.
It also doesn't matter. You know what I mean? On iTunes, this is really true. You can rename the album right now.
It doesn't roll off the tongue. Make America Innate Again is an odd coupling of words.
And yeah, so.
Well, the original name of the album.
What about something that rhymes with that? Like maybe Make America Great Again. Something like that.
Right.
That would work, right?
I don't think that's been used.
Right. Yeah.
Again, you are so much smarter than me.
I'm really good.
You are.
Do you not?
Are you being sarcastic?
Do you not like President
Trump?
I
am absolutely not being sarcastic, Lewis.
Don't you think audiences want us to support the president?
Well, here's the thing: the original name of the album was supposed to be
"This
Sit Down."
It.
It was that, and then the another name was supposed to be "Sit Down and Shut Up, You Morons." But some people thought that was a bit harsh.
Now,
you know, telling someone to sit down.
I mean, it's also the
much.
Only way you can get people to pay attention.
The name of the album was Sit Down and Shut Up, You Morons. And then you said, let's scrap that and go with Make America Innate Again.
Because telling someone to sit down, I feel, is crossing some kind of
get line. In the gas chamber, kikes.
Here's a question.
What's
aren't
my baby
they
album?
Already sitting if they're at the show?
That's true. Well, not. It's a bar show.
So
they only have a
what's
dozen
it called?
Seats.
Sean, I just put it out of my name. What's
Sean
it called?
Bowman's?
Sean Bolins?
Bolins.
The Make America Innate Again, though, was recorded at the
what does that
Haverty
mean?
Grace.
Tell us what it means.
It was recorded at the Haverty Grace Opera House.
Oh, okay.
So I stepped up a little bit from the Irish.
Well, that's
pub.
Very good.
Okay, so that's a little bit better.
How many seats are in there?
A lot more than at Sean Bolins.
Okay.
Yeah.
So was the crowd better, or were they a little stuffy? It seems like maybe they're a little stuffy, the Opera House.
No, I mean, the crowd was good. You know, the audio quality came out great, and people seemed to love it.
How
otherwise,
many albums do
keep,
you have?
They
you're prolific. You
it.
Have, like, a lot of albums.
I have four.
Okay.
One of them, the first one, was a mixture of live and studio stuff. This is from clips from my old college radio show. The second one, the Pitchforks one, was all live. The third one was clips from a podcast I did.
You can't do that. You can't clip in podcasts into your fucking albums. Yeah, sure. I have fucking 800 albums.
Tom, we did 3 albums last week.
I can because you gave me the real ass dude drop. So that's true. I can.
But this is interesting. But you're so.
Or did I just get it taken away now?
But I think when most people think of albums, they think of stand-up comedy performed in front of an audience. But you've mixed them in.
You say you don't care. You're like, fuck it, dude. It's almost like.
Are these live podcast clips or just clips from a podcast?
They're clips from a podcast that I
not in front of an audience. But do you think it takes? Do you think it takes people out of the album if it's like joke laughing, and then now this guy's just talking in a room?
Well, no, because this the third one that I did was
they sound surprisingly similar, actually.
Okay,
amazingly, yes, with the 15 people who were in the Irish pub, right. 15 people who were in the Irish pub, and nobody in a podcast.
Were any of them prepared?
Similar?
Did any of them come for the album taping, or were they just drunk?
They came for opera.
Not happy.
They came for opera, and
it's
you walked out.
It's Maryland, so they just wandered in drunk, and I think so.
So
we really don't have anything to celebrate.
What's the format of the fourth album?
It was "Make America Nate Again." That was the live. That was the live show at the Opera House.
Okay.
I taped and performed.
Yeah. Did you film it? Was it a special as well, or
it's just an audio album? Recording?
Okay.
I don't because I don't have the. I don't want to do the film stuff. Like the releasing it as a special.
Your forehead?
Because it would take, the forehead would take up the entire screen.
You have to have one of those, like, those swiping camera shots with a helicopter.
You've been doing comedy while. You're like a vet.
Yeah, 18 years.
Okay, that's awesome. You got a bunch of albums, and, you know, I mean, when did you start stand-up?
You started when you were 18 years old.
Yes.
Wow. What year was that?
2001.
This is a different time.
So you started during 9/11?
Yep.
That's what happened. The people flying the planes were flying away from Maryland. Yeah, like, I gotta get out of here.
Hold on. Wait a minute. So did 9/11 inspire you to start?
Absolutely.
Okay.
It just gave me the hope and despair and said, well, this happened. I can't do anything successful with my life, so I'll just go ahead and
You're like
I felt oddly.
It was a life affirming moment.
I was
for
like,
me.
I'm 3,000 productive people just got taken out of the equation. Yeah. Put me in the game, coach. But you didn't feel like that.
In life, everyone, if you want to look at the silver lining in 9/11,
absolutely.
Is we all moved up 300 spaces
up.
In life.
I know that from Luis Gomez. That's the way we
it's
think
true.
About the world.
We moved up 3,000 spaces in life. The opportunity, it's awful.
That's what my parents said to me. They sat me down at the table and they go, listen, you just moved up. They're like, this is not good.
No matter what way you measure it, you moved up.
So when you and
real estate opportunities went up in that area too, I hear
it's very true.
But in the immediate aftermath, I don't know. But so you start
dry cleaning. Yes,
took a while, but that's
a lot of people had suits right.
They're selling vacuum cleaners like a motherfucker.
What
downtown.
Drove you to comedy? Why did you love comedy? What did it?
If you were a vacuum cleaner salesman, September 12th, Lower Manhattan,
right?
Wowza, you crushed it that
what,
week.
What
you retired that day?
Yeah. What drove you into comedy? What did you love about? Like, what was it?
I just love the attention-grabbing aspect of it.
Yeah.
And
you mean just going into a room where people kind of have to listen to you?
Exactly.
Yeah, they're kind of trapped.
Like a hostage situation.
And they
were you
to.
Always,
I love
were
it.
Were you always the funniest person of your friends?
Not really, no.
Right. That's a weird thing.
Where are the other friends now? Where are they?
Oh, they are probably making much more money than me right now.
Doing comedy.
Do you haven't kept in touch with any of them?
Through social media.
Who was your funniest friend growing up? Out of all the kids you knew?
Honestly, I don't remember.
You don't remember. You didn't hang out with funny people.
Honestly, I blocked out a lot of stuff before this show because I needed to mentally
were you raped at one point?
I needed
why
to mentally
are you
prepare.
Things?
I needed to mentally prepare for this show. So that's why I went ahead and blocked everything out.
So when you started doing comedy, did you experience success right away? Did it take a while? What was like the journey?
Started performing at coffee houses where I went to school.
Okay, where'd you go to school?
Goucher College.
Where is
it
that?
It is a little bit north of Baltimore.
Goucher.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so you started doing coffee house circuits.
It's also what you do to your ears when you hear Tom's comedy.
Gouge
your ears out.
My name's not Nick Mullen.
That's right. So,
don't fuck with me, Tom. I remember that comment from the beginning of the show. I'm here.
At Goucher College, I know you're fucking that's when you learned the craft. Yeah, it was that era?
Yeah, pretty much.
And then when did you start taking it seriously?
When I do, I'll let you know.
Okay.
Nice,
this is
dude.
It's a game for Tom. He doesn't give a shit. He's not playing the same bullshit game that we are.
Right.
Okay, he's just living life.
He's living
floating
life.
Out there.
I envy this man.
Yeah.
He's free. There's a real freedom.
You're not making a lot of money, though?
I'm at the point now where I really don't need to perform. I'm involved in a lot of other stuff right now.
Dangerous.
So, human trafficking.
I'm involved in a lot
children.
Of other, you know, I got a couple
it's
nine to five.
It's the shadiest answer I've ever heard. He's like, I'm involved in a lot of things, managing a Chili's. Deep in the game, motherfucker. Involved in a lot of things, making sure Southwestern egg rolls hit the table.
Fuck yeah.
At an appropriate time, you know, keeping the line cooks going, you
fuck
know, put
yeah.
that queso in the bowl, boys.
I don't need to be
on a mic tonight.
I don't need to be in show business.
What are you doing to make money? Do you have a day job? Is that what it is?
I am an assistant manager of a restaurant, and on the weekends, I also do public
did
address announcing.
Did I nail
you
it?
You called it. You called it.
Is it Chili's? I love Chili's.
It's not Chili's.
Is it, okay.
What
it
is
a chain?
It's a real Mexican restaurant.
Okay.
Taco Bell.
But,
it's
how,
not,
but
no.
Literally, how close was I? I said you yelled about queso.
That's pretty fucking good.
That's pretty good. I have a little ESP. My mother always said
if
that.
You came out at my Mexican restaurant, I would ask for a refund immediately. Like, what the fuck does this guy know about
Mexican? Is it fair, do you think, and honestly, too, because you're on the left. You're a liberal guy.
Right.
Is it fair that a white guy is managing a Mexican restaurant with all the Mexicans that could be doing that job?
I'll be honest. They needed my signature for the liquor license.
I understand.
So.
No, you heard it first. Tom thinks that Mexicans are rapists.
Is it a good Mexican restaurant? Is it authentic?
Oh, yes.
Okay. If me and Luis Gomez go in there, a little discount.
Mr. Gomez.
Luis J. Gomez.
Would you hook us up with free lunch? Do you have the power to hook us up with free lunch? Do you have the power to hook up Nick Mullen with a free drink at your restaurant?
No.
Wow.
I'm consistent.
You wouldn't.
I am
but you
consistent.
Could if you wanted
so
to.
20 years. 20 years.
You could if you wanted to.
Listen, there's nothing wrong with managing a restaurant. It's honest work. It's better than most comics, you know? It's honest, good work, you know?
That's not a problem.
Right.
Are you trying to build the Politipod? When did you get so into politics?
Give us an example of Politipod. Like, let's pretend we're on the show right now.
Yeah, we're on
me,
Politipod.
Tim Dillon, Zack, Amico, we're the guests on Politipod. Usually what we do on this show, this is a segment that I have.
Yeah.
I shouldn't say usually because it's the first time
it's
I had
the idea.
It's
called Honoring the President. We give the guest a minute to honor our President Donald Trump.
Yeah, it's called Name the Problems with Chicago. Go.
Well, it's not that kind of podcast.
So
we do one liners
no,
and
on,
sketches.
Let me tell you. Okay, so look,
we're going to give him the show for a minute. We're going to give him the show.
You're getting the show uninterrupted 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Seconds.
We're on Politipod.
Well, but usually what we do is we play the intro for the show, but there's no intro for Politipod. Right?
No, there is. If you go to
she said she
checked
like six different episodes and it's all different intros.
That is correct.
Really?
So let's play
I
one of
the
them.
Most recent four. No.
Let's just play one of them.
Just play an intro.
The most recent
something.
Is,
you know, I'll play just any intro. How about that?
Welcome to Politipod.
That's a whole intro.
All right. Now you go. Now it's yours.
That was a Shanahan, by the way, Tom. You see that?
I see that.
You know
yes.
what that is?
It's very creative.
Do you know what that is?
Very creative.
Those are breasts.
It's a camera.
Those are breasts.
Right.
Falling down anytime we show Shannon.
Nice, dude.
She looks so
thrilled.
Yeah,
they need
thrilled.
To be replaced.
She looks
no, also
thrilled.
Look, a little bit of cleavage today, so my tip jar.
Oh, yeah, let me see that tit jar. I'm going to put some money in it. I see that fucking cleavage, Shannon. You get rewarded every time. Look.
Tom, yay. This is progressive. It doesn't feel like it is, but it is progressive.
I'm giving
I
her
tell
money.
You what, it's women. It's very liberating.
I'm supporting
I enjoy it. You're
women's
being very,
rights.
You're being very open-minded.
Shannon, come here. Get your tit jar in here. Come on, baby.
The
come
best
baby,
part of that this
shake.
From my end was I watch him pull out a 20 and go fuck no and
no,
stuff it
they
back.
That, she ain't showing that much cleavage. For a 20, I'm putting him in between her boobs with my teeth. There we go, right there in the tit jar. Come on, guys, put it in the tit jar. Look at those fucking honkaroonies.
Hell yeah, dude.
Shannon, do a little fucking dance for us. Come on. Shannon, this is not sexual harassment. That is literally just being complimentary and giving you money.
You know she dressed like this because Tom was in today.
Of course she did.
She's throwing it out there.
Shannon, would you fuck Tom?
I have a height requirement. That's the only reason. Yeah, that's it. He's just, if you were a little shorter,
he's
be
too
in.
Tall. I get it.
Too big, yeah.
How tall are you? 6'5", 6'6"? What is that?
About 6'3".
Okay. 6'3". Nick Mullen, you know, Nick Mullen's very short.
He's not that tall.
Does that make you feel better that you're so tall and he's so fucking petite?
Oh, fuck yeah.
I know. So, we're on Politipod. You take over right now. Give me 120 seconds on the clock. We're guests today on your show.
Joining us in studio, we have the one, the only, the uncompromising Louis J. Gomez. Louis, welcome to Politipod.
Hey, thanks, Tom. Thanks for having me. I really appreciate being here. Thank God there's no black people here.
So, judging by that comment, I would presume that you are
smart,
somewhat, not exactly
right,
to the left
with
of
reality.
You would say you are not exactly to the on the left end of the political spectrum. How would you describe your politics?
I don't believe in politics, Tom. It's all a figment of your imagination.
So you would say if you were to join a political party, you would be in the nihilist party, the American nihilist party.
If I joined a political party, it would turn into a fucking party. Am I right, people? Am I right?
Cue audience cheering.
Would there be audience cheering?
Yeah, we have a sound effect. There we go. That is exactly the kind of sound effect we
I
have.
Made it a real political party. Everyone's doing coke. We're fucking fingering young girls that are passed out.
So, Louis, are you planning to announce your candidacy for presidency of this new party in 2020? Are you going to run for president of the American Nihilist Party?
Yes, I am, Tom.
Well, this is a big Politipod exclusive. And so...
Do you really talk like that on the show? No, do you go Politipod exclusive?
He's joking right now. He's doing the absolute worst thing possible to be as a bit. I understand that.
Right.
It's fucking hilarious.
I get it. I'm with it. Because if I had heard, if that was a podcast and I was in my car and I was listening to that, I would crash my car into something.
Yeah.
Just because it's too formulaic. You know?
Right. It's
too formulaic.
It's talk radio. What do you expect?
Too high a production. You got to dumb it down.
I need it to be raw. It needs to feel authentic and real. And you felt very stilted and scripted. Kind of like Hillary Clinton, which is maybe why she lost.
Oh, shit. Here we go. We're getting political.
Absolutely.
Stray away.
Here comes the anti-woman thing from James.
Whoa.
I don't know who that is.
Who's James?
Who's James?
James Corden? Isn't that who you are?
Oh, I wish. That is good, though. He's British. We're both chubby.
Oh, I got it.
I see what
he just smashed you. Yeah. Fuck yeah, dude.
Give me that.
Guest attack?
Give me that attack. He just got me.
He just smashed him.
He just said I was James Corden. He just compared me to a guy who's worth tens of millions of dollars who has his own show. Damn it. Fuck.
Well, that's what Tom's
I'm
against.
Giving you
Tom's
something
against
to
successful shows.
He doesn't
you
know? Like. He doesn't.
I'm giving you something to shoot.
Who
for.
Who is your favorite comedian?
That's a fucking
question. I had it earlier and
Holy
I just put it in my
shit.
Pocket. And now I took it out of my pocket.
Wow.
So I want to hear it. He doesn't like James Corden. He doesn't
living
like
or
Nick.
Dead.
Let's just say whatever.
I like George Carlin,
Hack.
Lenny Bruce,
Gag.
And even going back as far as W.C. Fields.
Nigger.
Believe it or not.
Now, what about alive today, like breathing?
Lewis Black.
Okay. Okay.
I don't have anything else to say about
He's
that.
Named my least two favorite things.
Zack did not get enough credit on that. My two least favorite things, Lewis and Black.
Zack!
Ah, okay, Tom, we got to work on your podcast.
We got to get it a little better.
Yeah, we got to figure something out. Maybe a hip-hop beat. But
do you have a Patreon, or how are you making money? Are you just ad rev, or...?
You may find this a bit surprising, but we are not making any money as of yet.
No okay. money.
You may find that a shocker.
But you've been doing it only a few years.
Right.
And you can build it.
We're slowly working on it. Emphasis on
who
slowly.
Does it? Who's we? It's you and who else?
Who else?
Catch
the show is run by Matt.
His assistant manager. The corporate.
Would you have right-wing people on the show? Would you have an Ann Coulter or someone?
We would, yeah. I mean, anybody who, you know.
No, she won't. She's not going to come on.
Anybody who wants to, that's not us.
Right.
That's not you? There's another show called Politipod?
That is a ripoff artist. They started that show after we did.
Wait a minute.
We lean more to the left. This Politipod leans to the right.
It's a little confusing.
Hold on. We're just very confused.
That's a this confusing thing right there.
There is a more successful show called Politipod.
With the icon, I think, is Hitler.
And you're
not, with the host Tom Byers.
Yeah, and you're still keeping the name Politipod.
Mom's Tires.
You won't.
He winked at me after that joke. Fucking hardcore shit right there. Now, he didn't give a fuck.
Do you ever think of changing the name of Politipod? Because there's another show with the same name.
Yeah. And
they stole from us. And who do you think is more real? Us or this guy? Who do you think is more badass?
I mean, he's got a Hitler as his profile picture. I'm not hating that. That's not my least favorite thing. And it's not that I like Hitler. I like what he did.
Real recognizes real.
Real recognizes real, but boy, we had Hitler on the show one time. Do you know that?
That was the very first episode I listened to.
Have you ever tried to sue these people at Politipod who've stolen you and your essence in the show?
I'll be honest. I rate them slightly below
them?
The CumTown people, yes. And yes. Fucking I rate them slightly below the CumTown people and the trash collection people.
What is the deal with trash collection?
He doesn't like people working. I mean, garbage. That's an honest job. I mean, it's a good
those
city
people
job.
Make 100 grand a year.
Good money, dude.
We need
Mike Recine's funny.
What's interesting about so you're a liberal, but you really kind of I'm guessing there's a little hatred for the working class.
Taking jobs away from Mexicans, first of all, and you're trashing trash men, which is ironic.
I just have a hatred of everybody.
Okay.
Which is it's a very egalitarian way of living, I think.
Okay.
Egalitarian. Was that Daenerys Targaryen's brother?
Yes.
That was her brother.
Yep. You got, I tell you what, you are. Targaryen.
Are you a Game of Thrones fan, Tom? Yeah, are you Egalian a Thrones Targaryen. Man?
Not really.
Not really?
I've never watched any of the episodes. I don't.
So that would be
I don't
no.
really care.
That would, yeah. You don't need to say why, not
what
really.
Is it? It's
just a no.
Too many fans and makes too much money?
Something like that,
he just
yeah.
hates that. That concept of fucking fans and money.
He doesn't like it.
It's his least favorite thing. I get it. I'm with you.
Hell yeah, no, dude. I tweeted about Game of Thrones the other day. You know who retweeted me? Ben Shapiro.
Oh, hell yeah.
Jew.
Do you like Ben? No, you're not. You don't like. Would you have him on your show?
Do you want to have an open forum, right?
You got to have different. Do you think Donald Trump opinions? Has any good points? Can you give Donald Trump a compliment?
You got to give him something.
Give him something.
I think
I know you don't like him.
I think that for a grandfather in his 70s, he's great at using Twitter.
I agree.
Fuck yeah.
Okay.
I agree.
Yeah.
The show, you should change the format. We should change the name, and we should change the format.
The Politipod is a little... It's
political stuff is hack anyway, guys. Yeah, we don't talk about politics on the show for that reason. Do you see
what if...
We started talking about politics on the show, and it brought the show to a screeching halt.
Right.
Okay.
What if we change the name of the show to the Real Ass Politipodcast?
That's better.
It's better, but it's still the problem is the Politipod, the Politipodcast, the Politipod. This is the problem. Like, make America innate again. These are they. It's not a fun thing to say. Like, and you might not like it, but CumTown's kind of a fun.
It is fun to say.
It's just fun.
It sounds
to
like
say.
A fun place, especially if you're gay. Like
it
Tim,
sounds like a very
Tim hears
fun
that place.
Thing.
He's like, okay, sign me up. Give me one way ticket to CumTown.
Sure,
right?
But Politipod or make America
Ooh,
innate
I
want to
run. Give me a bus ticket.
There's too
of
many
Politipod.
Words. Too many words.
That sounds like a shit town, Politipod town.
You need just one to two words.
Actually, Politipod's only one word.
I know, but Politipod, it's a lot of
syllables. Those are called syllables, yeah. There you go.
I know.
Those are called syllables, yeah.
Thank you, Tom. But it's still bad. That's the problem. You got to come up with a
syllable,
better...
Syllable, that's the girl that Tyrion Lannister was married to. The hooker.
Yes,
I know.
Syllable.
Yeah, she was great.
You have to just come up with one word or two words that are monosyllabic, that's just boom, boom.
And if I don't want to?
Well, I mean, we're just trying to help. I just want
to
grow
help.
Your
we,
audience.
You have another show out there with the same name. Imagine I started a show called Westworld, and I was like, this is my new show.
Who are some comedians right now that you don't like, that you just see,
Give
you
me
go,
one
this
name.
Guy's overrated?
Three syllables.
What
go.
Do you think? You look at Sebastian Maniscalco, you go, this guy's talented, or you go, I'm not, it's not for me.
Tons
for
of
who?
Syllables.
Sebastian Maniscalco.
Sebastian.
You go, you don't know who he is?
No.
Okay, he's not. He's a young guy. He's new. He's not really doing much. What about a guy like a guy like a Chris Rock or Louis C.K.
I liked Louis C.K. before all that before all that stuff came out about him.
Now you don't like him anymore.
Yeah, I mean, he's pretty much it's pretty much reminds me of just every single scumbag that you meet in this business.
So you're saying Louis C.K. is a scumbag?
Well, it was a scumbag. It was a scumbaggy thing that he did. I mean, I recognize that he's trying to, you know, rehabilitate.
Let me ask you a question.
Do all that good stuff, yeah.
What about him reminds you of the scumbags you've met in the business?
Just the overall creepiness and wanting to take advantage of female comics.
People want to.
Is that what people are trying to do when you walk into a room? You feel guys get creepy and they're trying to.
Given that I have the build of a woman, yes, I am very.
Do you think there should be a road to redemption for someone like Louis, who's clearly a comic genius? But
I have an idea. What if he completes every mission in Red Dead Redemption?
Yeah, is there a way? Is there like a American Ninja Warrior style obstacle course that he could do? Is there anything Louis could do to get back in your good graces? You're a good hover to grace.
He should go on. He should do every single task in Reddit Redemption, like Lewis said.
Red Dead Redemption.
Red Dead Redemption.
Reddit Redemption is what's going to happen after this show, because there's going to be a lot of people that have a lot to say about this.
That was a Freudian slip right there. You got Reddit on your mind right now. Are you nervous that
you ever go on Reddit or 4chan or 8chan?
No.
You've never gone on Reddit.
I've never posted anything on Reddit.
They call them lurkers. The people just read the stuff. Search Tom Myers on Reddit really quick.
Do you ever? Are you dating? Do you have a lady? Do you have a gentleman? What's your? Are you in the dating world?
Oh, do you? What? Yeah, he's like bisexual, like eccentric, like fucking David Bowie.
Say once you get to a certain level of success in the entertainment business, you just start fucking.
Who cares?
Got the David Bowie hair thing going on.
I know,
on
dude.
Right.
No, not dating anyone.
Okay. Not dating anyone.
No.
But you're just crushing a lot of puss. I'm Tom Myers.
Oh, so you did an AMA.
You've been on Reddit before you posted.
That's not me.
Oh.
It's not you.
Oh, please provide proof that you were the real Tom. I see. Okay.
Oh, it was you. Somebody pretended to be. This happens a lot. People pretend to be you.
Yeah.
Let's see.
That's
Tom
not
Myers.
Me.
This isn't you either. Tom_Myers.
Nope. I'm not on Reddit.
Wow. See, I thought that these were you right now.
Nope.
This is all on CumTown. Look, no. This is actually your profile. Look. Tom Myers is a comedian who tackles any subject, whether the topic is current events, social or political issues, or a topic other comedians would not even approach. Tom is not afraid to make you laugh about using a straight-talking, no-holds-barred manner. In addition to being a comedian, Tom is an actor, sports PA announcer.
That's not a bad bio.
And an event MC with several years' experience performing. That's a great bio. Did you write that, or did they write that?
I wrote the bio, but they copied it from the website.
Tom, okay. This is you. Don't lie to us.
It's not me.
No, I don't. I believe him.
You believe that it's somebody else?
It's probably somebody else. Hmm. I mean... but again, I'm just basing it on what Tom is saying.
Tom, if there's one thing that you could say to Nick Mullen right now, just one thing, okay? Look at the camera. Which camera would he be looking at? You should look at one of them. That one? That one right there? All right. If there's one thing you could say to Nick Mullen right now, zoom in on Tom a little bit. Can we make it just about him for a second? Shannon, Jesus Christ. Got fucking Tim, watching Tim breathe hard.
I'm not breathing. I'm breathing pretty.
I said I'm watching you breathe hard.
I'm breathing
it.
No harder than Stavros.
Your mic diction is fucking incredible lately.
What is that? Oh, my. Just the way.
Yeah, you just fucked.
He's getting turned on by your breathing. Stop it.
Get in there. Zoom in, though. I want to fucking really get in there. This is a moment. His moment to talk to fucking Nick. Shannon, when I say zoom, fucking zoom on the guy, okay?
That's enough.
Maybe a little closer. Just really in the eyes. Really, really getting there. We're good. Maybe even a little closer.
I can't go any further.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what she said.
No, fuck no, dude.
No, he was a good joke. Shut the fuck up, Stav. Stav's actually in the booth. We wouldn't let him in the studio, but that's really Stav.
I was wondering why it looked cramped in there.
Oh, shit! Wow!
He is overweight.
He's a fat guy.
He's overweight.
Smash his tooth. What have you thought about his missing tooth?
I always wondered how he managed to get into show business. Apparently, whatever was in his mouth that made him, get whatever good things he has going for him right now. Probably knock that tooth out.
Do you think that's a homophobic remark? Like when people say Trump and Putin hook up, do you think as a liberal that it's right to insinuate that homosexual activity is a negative?
No, that's just my disdain for all people.
Including gays. Yeah. He would be, he hates gays as well. So you're saying right now, you hate trans people.
And Muslims.
And straight people.
No.
I hate everybody.
Answer one question at a time. One question at a time.
You hate trans people.
I hate everybody.
No.
I hate everybody.
Tom.
You hate Muslims.
I hate everybody.
No, Tom, one at a time. Just yes or no. Simple yes or no questions.
You still go to Sean.
It's a yes or no game.
You still go to Sean Bowens.
No.
Okay. You hate Muslims.
No.
You just said you hate everybody.
Except Muslims. Muslims are the only people you like.
I hate white people a lot more.
Why do you hate white people? Why? You're a white guy.
Is it because of what happened to Sean Bolins?
What do you hate about white people? It's a self thing. Just the fact that they do the stuff that they've done in the past.
But do you think that they're the only people doing bad stuff? I mean,
yes.
Really?
Yep.
Have you ever met a Puerto Rican?
Yeah, I mean, Lewis is Puerto Rican. He's horrific.
I'm a bad person.
He's never done anything bad.
Tom, I raped your co-host before the show.
But Tom,
name one bad thing that you've done.
Said the N-word 4 times on today's show.
Oh, I didn't hear that.
And he's only half of an N-word, so he can't.
So he doesn't even hear. Some people don't see color. He doesn't even hear.
Wasn't he going to make a statement?
Statement right now to Nick Mullen. Go right at the camera.
So Nick, if you're watching this, I know you love to focus on a bit that I was doing 10 years ago, and you love to bring it up, and you love to tell your fans to go ahead and use it as much as possible in replies on Twitter, Instagram, and such, but keep in mind that is during the time when I was a traveling road comic and you were still an open micer.
So look at the two of you now.
Yeah. Oh, yes. He's on, what's the name of that podcast again?
I don't even...
Hold on, he's not done. Let him keep going.
Sorry, I don't want to interrupt.
So I would love to go back to that. If you want to go ahead and focus on, what was that, about 2007, 2008? Actually, it's
even more than 10 years ago.
Even more than 10 years. So, and
you want to say to Nick Mullen? Because you sort of, you know, there wasn't much of a point there. You sort of fell off at the end.
Can I say something to Adam Friedland, please? Can I say something to Adam Friedland? Thank you. Let me tell you something right now. You know that I can do things to you that would make...
Wrong camera, Tim.
It doesn't matter where I'm looking. You're a beautiful boy, and you're marrying that communist whore. Let me do it right.
Listen to daddy.
Thank you. That's all. Thank you.
Hell yeah, dude.
So yeah, I mean, look, dude, I think the reality is you let CumTown have it today. And also, I feel like you're holding back, too. If you really wanted to,
you were diplomatic. You think maybe you guys will work on a project together in the future, and I understand.
Yeah. Would you do a show with them at this point? Because I know we've talked in the past, and you said, no, I will not do anything involving Nick Mullen or CumTown. But maybe could you let bygones be bygones? If they said, hey, dude, we want to we're going to do a CumTown web series. We want you to come and guest on it one day. Would you do something like that?
No.
Why not? What's the reason?
I just
never... think maybe it's cutting off your nose to spite your face, because you got to go back to that Mexican restaurant,
right?
Look all those people in the face.
What do you mean those people?
Well, you know what I mean.
What do you mean those people? The white customers we have. What do you have against white people, Lewis?
You know what I fucking mean.
Do I,
Tom?
I don't think I fucking know what you're talking about.
Don't sidestep the question.
What are your plans for the future, Tom? What are you looking to get into in the future?
We
talked a lot about the past today, but we need to put that to bed.
It's done. We're officially done with CumTown.
We're done with the past.
This feel at
cathartic?
All? Yeah.
Oh, very cathartic. Yes.
It did, right? It did. Did you get it off your chest? Did you feel like you finally were able to sort of put this to bed? Because they're watching. You know they're watching right now.
I know they're watching.
Yeah.
I feel like I can go out and get a real job now.
Yeah.
Well, you have one.
Yeah. You have a couple of real jobs.
You have a few. Mm-hmm. Nine to fives.
So look, here's the thing. We're gonna take some callers. 573-GAS-LINE. 573-GAS-LINE is the phone number. If you guys want to ask any questions for Tim Dillon, Tom Myers, or anybody, you can call in at any time now. Harrington will be answering the phone calls. We got a couple other things to talk about on today's show. We're gonna definitely...
Alabama just made it illegal for women to have abortions. Tom, let's stop the murder. Am I right?
Come on, man. They're people. As soon as you detect a heartbeat, they're people.
They're babies, and they should be alive.
It's also the people least...
Correct. Whatever you're going to say, you're correct.
The people that should be killed least.
Yes.
Babies.
Let's not kill babies.
The most innocent of all.
You're in favor of killing people, but these people...
Well, now, let me ask you a question, Tom. Where do you stand on this issue of abortion? You're a political man.
Right. I feel that as a man, as someone of not of the childbearing gender, I don't feel as though I have any right to tell a woman who...
I also think that women should say it to men's issues, like fucking banking. And
voting.
The roads, how elevators work. Women shouldn't... Elevators. So, Tom, you're saying women shouldn't be able to use elevators. I agree.
You're saying that this abortion ban is wrong.
Correct.
Okay. The Alabama Senate. We'll have to see what
I guess you would
out.
You would know more than an entire state's justice system.
Have you ever paid for a lady to terminate a pregnancy?
It wasn't the justice system. That was the legislature.
You don't know anything about this stuff, Tom. This is what I do for a living.
He's a political analyst.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Have you ever paid?
You're already the nominee for the American Nihilist Party for President of the United States in 2020.
Have you ever thought of having a baby? Have you ever held a baby in your hands? Like a baby, like a warm baby, why would you kill that baby?
Give me a reason. Because give me five reasons.
Because that baby could be the next Nick Mullen.
Interesting.
Wow. So you think Nick Mullen deserves death?
So you're saying it's okay to abort autistic babies?
So you're saying
I believe in that. Okay, that actually one thing I can stand with you on.
Mm-hmm.
Second, that baby could grow up to be the next Nick Mullen.
Right.
You said that one already.
No, I didn't. Third. That baby could grow up to be the next Nick Mullen.
This is like being John Malkovich, except they pulled money out of production. You know what I mean? It's a very interesting...
Four. That baby could grow up to be the next Nick Mullen.
How many are on this list?
And five...
Blacks aren't people.
I hate the noise they make on airplanes.
Okay. That's joke. It's a comedic rule of five.
War with Iran. Yes. No.
Do we have a caller? All right, you're on the Real Ass Podcast. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
It's a mime.
One sec, sorry.
Oh, the phones are ringing off the hooks. In there.
It's a mime.
What's your name? Where are you calling from? You didn't put it through, you dumb fucking assholes.
I mean, the producers.
It's crazy.
Here.
It's fucking crazy.
If Rogan had them, he'd break their necks on screen.
You have... Not one job, but what? Four jobs, and you can't do it right.
Okay, do we have somebody on the line now? Or did you guys not figure out how to take these calls?
One second, hold on.
The phones are just ringing off like crazy. Tom, they want to talk to you. This is a big fucking
deal.
There's
people out there that probably like the abortion ban, I would imagine.
What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Louis J. Tom in Philly. What's up, brother?
What's up, Tommy boy? Philadelphia at the house. How you feeling, baby? What do you got to ask?
Awesome. This is the greatest show I've ever seen, Louis.
Oh, thanks, man.
Ultimately, though, you guys transitioned off that little fag's sexuality. Would he, my question for Tom is,
Tim?
would he let Tim fuck him in the ass?
That is true. We didn't get the answer.
Tom from
that.
Philly has some good ideas.
Yeah, thank you
I'm
very
trying
much.
To hook you up, Tim.
Thank you very much, Tom. Yo, that cheesesteak's trash, though. Bad sandwich. Keep going, sir.
You're going to the wrong place, Tim.
Where do you got to go, first of all, Tom? Where's the place to go?
Yeah, where do you go?
John's Roast Pork. John's Roast Pork is the only place to go. It's in South Philly. It's sort of by the stadiums. It's giant fat sandwiches.
Okay.
It's awesome.
You know what? All right. I'm going
to
try it.
You went to a fucking lunch thing the other day. It kind of bothers me. Wait, I'm one of your more successful friends.
Thing?
People don't realize it because I dress like a scrub.
Yeah.
But I'm doing pretty good, okay?
What lunch thing did I go to?
Schultz and fucking Giannis.
Yeah. We had a nice restaurant. We had a nice dinner.
I'm just saying, you don't invite me to nice dinners. Why don't we go to some fucking
dinners? We were doing a show at Gotham.
Dave Smith, how you doing, my brother?
Okay, so Tom is straight or gay?
He's transitioning.
That's the question, right?
He's transitioning to his more
social friends. Are you straight or gay, Tom?
Straight.
You're straight. What's the last time you fucked?
I don't believe that.
Why are you saying that,
Tom in Philly? Because Tom's no Toms. That's actually a thing in the world.
Oh, interesting.
Tom's no Toms. So, Tom, thank you very much, Tom from Philly. You can hang up on him now.
You guys rule.
Why do you...
Tom's
no Toms. Why do you think that you're straight?
Because I am.
Okay.
Have you ever hooked up with a man?
No.
So you don't know.
You have no idea.
Right.
No, but I know what I look like, and I just presume that most men look as grotesque as me.
That is not true.
No, no, no. You are the lower rung. Yeah,
no, there's a lot of good looking men. I will say that. Have you ever looked at like a TV show or a movie?
Have you ever literally looked at any sign that's ever been
just
made?
Just walk around New York. You're walking around Sean Bolins. Maybe you're the top 10% of Sean Bolins, but let's get another caller.
Yeah, get another caller. 573-GAS-LINE if you want to call in live here on the Real Ass Podcast. Also, I'll take a moment really quick before we get our next caller on. If you love the show, every episode we've ever done available on demand at gasdigitalnetwork.com. Use the promo code RAP, get a 14-day free trial, have access to this show, 20 other incredible shows here on the Gas Digital Network, including Legion of Skanks, Tim Dillon's Going to Hell, Believe You Me, Zack Amico's Midnight Spook Show, and more. Pre-release, uncensored, live chat, all that good shit. Shannon, pull some questions from the live chat, too. Top two or three questions from the live chat. We're going to really get to know our guests today. 573-GAS-LINE, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, this is Cheeto Man, and I'm from Connecticut, a bit north of Havre de Grasse, and I have a question for Tom.
All right, sweet. Go, dude.
Thanks, Cheeto Man.
Hey, Tom. I'm getting into comedy, but I keep getting kicked out of clubs. I've gotten kicked out of 109 clubs. Do you think it's everyone else's fault, or is it mine? Is it something I'm doing, maybe? Thanks.
I think it might have something to do with your phone, because I couldn't understand a fucking word.
Oh, he said that he's been kicked out of 109 clubs.
Yeah, he wants to know if he's doing something his fault? Wrong.
You have to be kicked out of 120, so he needs to be kicked out of 11 more clubs.
How many clubs?
That's the rule of 120.
How many? Wait a minute.
What is this? It seems inside. Like, is this is an inside thing?
Well, I haven't really been kicked out. I haven't really been kicked out of any. Like, I've been asked not to come back to, like, a few.
109?
Not 109.
How many? How many clubs have you been asked to not come back to?
Probably. I could probably count them the number of fingers on one hand, probably.
So five.
Five.
Yeah. Five clubs.
Well, it depends. In Zach's family, or less. Six
five,
sometimes.
Yeah. Five clubs have said, we would like you to not
good thing he didn't say turn.
Okay. That's not horrible. I mean.
Kicked out, but they said specifically don't come back. Why was the reason? Too hardcore?
There were some instances where because I used to do this thing in my act where
parkour,
I would just
parkour, fuck yeah.
I would just berate audience members.
You'd
like
go
if they didn't like what I was saying.
But sometimes that's,
and a few of the clubs took exception to that.
But sometimes if you do that in a funny way, the audience likes it. They laugh.
Yeah, you just trash the audience a little bit. It's I do it all the time.
We always do it.
It's part of my act. You know, you do a little crowd work, but I always trash them, I go after them. So what happened? Were they not laughing when you were trashing them?
Some of them, they seem to enjoy it, I think, but then this is when
the
I
club
was...
club owners come in, they ruin the fun.
Those bastards. Yeah. And this was during my drinking days, I haven't, you know...
It's been 7.5 years since a club has
so you just get up there with a stomach full of fucking whiskey and crab bisque and start letting them have it.
Yeah, you didn't give a shit.
I couldn't even afford the crab bisque at the time.
Fuck it, you went
so
with
so I was just... Yeah.
Okay.
Whiskey and cheap beer.
Gaslight. If you want any comedy tips from Tom Myers.
Tom Myers will give you tips right now. Not just comedy tips, life tips. If you want to learn how to be a fucking real ass dude. Tom, when's the last time you got laid? I wanted to know that.
2012.
Whoa. 2012 is the last time you got laid?
I haven't been on a date since
then.
Come
lie. You just got to like lie. Nobody's
going to
fact check
this. But you can pay for sex. That's probably a good move.
Yeah, it's not that bad.
There's nothing wrong with that.
So you haven't been on a date, but we should get you laid. Is there any female listeners out there that would fuck Tom Myers for the story?
Call up.
573-GAS-LINE. You're on the line. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, Louis. This is Stevie in Seattle. How are you, man?
What's up, baby boy? Love your city. Love your fucking Seattle dogs, kid. My favorite Tom. Have you had a Seattle dog?
What's on a Seattle dog?
It's a long fucking like Italian sausage
hot dog. Years of a failed bassist? Come on!
And it's on like almost like an Italian style bun, like a thicker
fuck
bun.
With that, yeah.
With this work, it's crazy. It has fucking mayonnaise and onions.
All right, I'm not into that now,
nigga. Trust
me. What's it doing over there?
No, it's cream cheese, Louis.
Oh, that's what I meant. I'm sorry. Cream cheese. It's fucking harder. I'm stupid. Cream cheese and onions.
I just lost all respect for you because you didn't get the cream cheese.
Get
part
your
correct.
Fucking finger out of my face, Tom. I know you're out alphaing me at all times, but I do not appreciate the physical stuff. Okay, I get a little fucking
edgy. So, Seattle, what's your question for Tommy? Or do you have?
Yeah, so I was calling in. You guys, you know, Tom kind of addressed the bong hit transplant controversy that's
What's
gone
bong
on
hit
in
transplant
the past.
Controversy.
And, that's the bit.
You guys are referring to the joke a lot, and I just was wondering if he would actually just do the joke. It's a really good joke.
I've heard the joke before. It's not the worst joke.
What's the joke?
It's a really good joke.
It's a joke about he's in a convenience store. Set it up.
Yes,
you're in a store.
So let's hear Tom do it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. You know, this is the best question of the day so far. You just want a real-ass podcast mug. Put him on hold. Get him a fucking real-ass podcast mug from the brand new...
And get his address and then swat him.
Brand new podcastmerch.com. Grab all of your podcast merch. Podcastmerch.com for my show and a bunch of other shows. Not just Gas Digital. This is across the board, baby boys. Tuesdays with Stories. I'm wearing my Shane Gillis, Matt and Shane Secret podcast shirt right now. Lots of amazing... brands coming.
You're
to
all about the support.
Merch.com. Yeah, now it's all making money off my friends. Anyway, so what is the setup? A joke. Bong hit transplant.
Well, it's been a while since I've done the bit, so it's gonna sound really horrible. I know something horrible coming out of me. Imagine that, right?
No way.
No way.
I don't believe it.
So the joke is, I'm in a convenience store waiting in line. Someone puts.
Pretend you're at a club right now. We're an audience. You got a microphone in front of you. Don't just say the joke is, you know, literally
we
say the joke.
We look like people that go to a comedy.
Yeah, we are Sean Boland's fucking
We're sitting
A-class.
There, second row, if there are rows.
Zack literally looks like the person who is in the second row on that Sean Boland show. So he is helping me.
Focus on him and deliver it.
Mm-hmm. So it's I go into a convenience store and the guy puts on the counter, I think, a dozen donuts, a 1 gallon jug of the cheapo brand fruit punch. Nasty
should
old
say the brand.
Brown
I feel like you
banana.
Can
let him do it.
But it'd be more, if you get more specific, it'd be funny. If you said Fago, it would be a funnier way to tell the joke. But anyway, go.
No, if they're not paying me to say it, I'm not saying it.
I'll give you all the money in Shannon's tip.
$2.
$2 deal. Go say it.
And nasty old rotten brown stinking banana, and the guy says to the clerk. My girlfriend just had an operation. She can only eat certain things. And I'm thinking to myself, yeah, right. What did she have? A bong hit transplant. It was a joke I wrote a long time ago. It was stupid. It got laughs. And, you know, I eventually, like most jokes, I got tired of telling it. And then
did it make
stopped.
Its way onto one of the albums?
I don't know.
Is
I don't,
it on Make
I don't
America
think so.
Innate again or? Words of Mass.
It may be on Pitchforks, but I don't.
Gotcha.
I don't.
I like how it calls it Pitchforks.
Now, explain to me the thinking behind the joke, because you see all of this. So it's like it's all this unhealthy food, and then you're right. Like, you know, this guy basically saying she can only eat certain foods after an operation. Now, I'm all with you on the premise,
right?
And then you go, what did she have? A bong hit.
It's the punchline. You're right.
Transplant.
You're right. It's not the premise.
The punchline is the issue.
Yeah.
That's the only issue with the joke.
Everything right. else is actually really good.
The premise
good.
Is kind of funny.
I love the premise.
The premise is not bad. The punchline
he
is
he could
where,
have said a...
That's the next
a
album. Just an album
of,
full of premises.
A cheapo type of soda.
Well, oh, let's just spitball here. You go like, oh, this guy puts all this disgusting food. He's got fucking M&Ms and Cheetos and...
See, that's my... Where I would go, what does a dirty banana have to
and
do
any,
with
any, anything involving food, Zack is in on it.
Yes, of course.
Oh, shit,
so this guy
Zach.
Puts...
Oh, in your fucking fat yeah. face. In your face. No one's safe.
But what does a dirty banana have to do with high people?
Because high people just eat anything.
Okay, well that's not true.
You're so you're trying nice, to you're I know what's going on. He's being racist.
I'm generalizing.
He's saying brown people.
But
are
so
the, ones who do
the
drugs.
Bong hit trans. But the only problem with that is that it doesn't make sense. The punch.
Yeah,
bong
once
hit.
You start to break down the punchline, and here's what you don't want it, people doing yeah. is when you tell a punchline, you don't want people to not laugh and think about why they're not laughing.
Right, and that's what I think this punchline does. It makes yeah. people want to leave the club.
Yeah, they go, no, that's not right. This
they go,
is an album.
Something's
favorite.
Wrong. They go, yeah. something is wrong here, and I should leave and
it's
not
an uncomfortable,
never come back.
It's an uncomfortable feeling.
It's not the move.
So it wasn't, what could have been a better punchline instead of bong hit
transplant? So it's got, let's say it's a transplant, right?
Some kind of operation, yeah.
Some kind of operation.
What, did she get her lungs replaced with the bong? That could have worked.
Okay, well that's...
What, does she have her lungs replaced with bongs?
That's better than bong hit transplant.
Yeah? I'm spitballing, man.
I would have been like, listen, it's like, what the fuck? You know,
well, I haven't done the bit in 10 years, so clearly I stopped liking
it. We could bring it back.
What kind of operation did this bitch have?
It could have went hard.
Yeah.
You know, like, oh, she fucking get raped, I bet. I would have liked it.
That could be on your next special. I give you permission to use that one.
I retired from comedy. I'm just trying to get a job at a Chili's.
My girlfriend just had an operation.
Fill out an application. I'll interview you.
I'll try.
What did she have her lower intestine replaced with a Mexican? But then you'd have to have Mexican foods.
That makes it less. It doesn't make sense, but it's funnier.
It's funnier.
It's funnier.
It's funnier.
A couple funny words in there.
You have a lower intestine replaced with a Mexican?
Remember, like Patrice said, how like Buick is a funnier word than Oldsmobile?
Yeah.
Mexican's funnier word than bong hit transplant.
Right. Or
any other word.
Yeah.
What did she ever, a lower intestine replaced with a malnourished, you know, child? I don't know. Like, what she just had a transplant. What kind of transplant?
You know my go-to punchline is?
What did she have her intestine replaced with family court? These are all dumb.
No,
these
my
are dumb.
You know, it's a stock punchline you could just use?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Female
yeah.
circumcision. Just throw it in
female
there.
Female circumcision. Let me tell you right now.
If you get female
yes.
circumcision into
He's
that
right.
bit, it would
He's
fucking
right.
crush.
Let's try it with
Guaranteed.
Female circumcision.
Go, Tammy.
I walked into this grocery store the other day. I see this guy. He's got Cheetos and M&M's. He's got the cheapo brand fruit punch. He's got a dirty banana.
Really dirty banana.
Filthy banana. And then
he says
to the clerk, he goes, my wife just had an operation. She can only eat certain foods. And I said, an operation? What? Did she have a clitorectomy? Was she circumcised?
Clitorectomy is a fucking great word.
Did they hack off her clit? Did they hack off her clit? Is that why you're buying a dirty banana?
This is why.
Your wife's clit was hacked off. But again, if you said that, it would be funny.
This is why he gets the gigs dressing up as Meghan McCain.
It's true.
Fuck yeah.
That's got a million views. I know you're shitting on that. It's got a million views.
Let's give it another caller. We got to wrap the show in a little while. We had all these segments planned, but this is just too good. I like the callers right now. 573 Gasline. If you want to talk to Tim Dillon or Tom Myers, any questions for any of our guests today, you're welcome. Go ahead. You're on the podcast. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
It's another mime.
Hello?
We can hear you breathing.
Did we ever find out what Make America Innate Again means?
No.
Thanks.
We didn't.
Screen
Tom.
These calls, Harrington. Screen the fucking calls. You can screen. You can pick them up and go, what's your call? What's your question? And then when they don't have a good question for the fucking mayor of fucking Funnyville, Tom Myers, you piece of shit. You're disrespecting our guest right now. I'm sorry, Tom.
The top of comedy in Havre Grace, Maryland.
How
the
about
king
this
of comedy
bitch?
In Havre
I know
Grace.
This bitch who had a clitorectomy. This is the urban version. I know this bitch who had a clitorectomy.
I do the punchline first.
And she be eating dirty bananas.
Dirty bananas.
That's not bad. Oh. That's not bad. Work backwards into it.
I like
is
it.
Dirty, is banana supposed to be a euphemism for the penis, Tim? Is that what you're saying?
No. No, I was just using your joke because the guy put the banana on the thing.
Yeah. Oh. You're coattailing off of me.
That's
man.
Right.
You're trying to bag me, dude.
Let's you know what? Fuck it. While we're waiting for another caller or two, if they want to call in, that's fine. Let's just do one actual segment that we normally do on the show because it's really been all focused on Tom Myers. I didn't realize how deep we were going to get into this.
It was like an episode of Unmasked.
Yeah, it was fucking incredible.
It was wild.
Let's do this scam that Jew.
Yeah.
Let's get a couple scams that going.
Yeah.
I'm a very desperate man, and I live with my mother.
Scam that. Jew.
Is that what a rabbi sounds like before he orgasms?
Yep.
Okay.
I fucking nailed it, dude. So, we have our fans write in the best scams. Little simple, easy to pull off scams, and then give away one lucky winner, a Scam That Jew t-shirt. Show that Scam That Jew t-shirt.
It's my favorite segment.
Yeah, it's great. These are great scams all the time. We've been getting really good ones lately as well. It's sort of a resurgence. We had a bunch of shitty scams for a while. If you want to join the conversation, there it is. Scam That Jew. Tom, you could chime in at any time as well. If you have a good scam, because you work on the inside of a restaurant, so you might be able
right.
to figure out a way that people get away with shit.
Yeah.
That's the way.
Sending food back.
That's the best way. So,
you ever pluck a lock? If I'm in your restaurant, can I take some of my hair out and just throw it on the burrito? 3/4 into eating it, and then will you take it back?
You got to be a little more original than that.
Okay. Harrin,
see, everybody Harrin, does that.
Harrin,
what about if it's pubic hair?
Harrington sent me a story that was really interesting that inspired this week's Scam That Jew. It was a guy, I think this is in England, and this would work. And another one was sent in recently. No, I'm sorry. Paul Versey told us one that was very similar. But this guy was arrested in England because he...
The guy was arrested in England.
He was arrested. Let me tell you how to...
Let me tell you how he was doing
sit down.
I was there with Bill Burr.
And then the guy said, the guy said, dude, do a podcast. And then he got arrested in England. And then we performed for a stadium of 8 billion people. And at the end of the day, I just realized, you know, I love my kids. I just performed for, there was about, and I'm not going to exaggerate. You know me, I don't exaggerate. About 30 billion people. In the stadium.
All right, go on. So what happened?
But then the look in my daughter's eyes made it all worth it.
So this guy in England, he would dress up in a suit.
Hello.
Hello. This is my...
I'm in a suit, love. That was the scam.
And he would show up at KFC, and he would act like he was from corporate, and he has to do like a food inspection, like
doing this
service
tomorrow,
dude. And he would show up and just get buckets of chicken and be like, "Yeah, I got to take this back to headquarters."
Did you say this was England?
Yeah, I think so.
I think you're on the wrong continent.
What do you mean?
Look at the universe. They showed the name of the universe. Doesn't sound English. KwaZulu-Natal.
Oh, every restaurant's KFC there. It's like Starbucks in Africa.
I am from Goplet. I must try all of the chicken. Okay?
I am the inspector now.
No, so I get, maybe it was Africa. I'm sorry. Yeah, Harrington, what?
This guy was actually balling. He would have his friend drive up in a limo, and he would get out in a suit and then immediately walk into the back and start, you know, checking things off and then just take all
the
chicken.
You don't even need the limo.
I love all of this to just get chicken. Like, literally, how expensive could chicken be in Africa? Like,
so the scam is you rent a limo.
Yeah. Well, in Africa, I feel like they live in limos part-time, probably. Like, some old broken-down limo. They're like, we could drive this over to the KFC and get dinner for our whole village. It's sadder because it's in Africa. And also, I feel like they also probably have specific menu items. You know, you do that.
They're good.
You go to Canada and it's a poutine and McDonald's menu.
Yeah, I bet South Africa's got some probably interesting, you know.
Just fried.
Fried snake.
Women clits.
I must try the fried clits. I am here from corporate. Please give me all of the fried clits to try.
Let's,
These bananas are very dirty.
These are the dirtiest bananas I've ever seen.
Dirty banana clits.
What type of person would have a banana that is so dirty?
Dirty banana
possibly
clits.
Someone that had a bong hit transplant. That is not funny in any language you say.
My wife just had an operation. She's only eaten certain things. I'm like, this guy's wife just had an operation. What does she have, a clitorectomy?
That's great. I know the punchline. It makes me laugh every time.
What did you chop off her clit?
You fucking dumb bitch with her big old clit.
You have a clitor.
It's like a big toe hanging off her pussy. Chop it off. Whoosh.
That guy in the scam was actually the guy who wrote the joke for me, so why I feel ripped off.
Fair enough.
Is there a phone call? Okay, fine. We'll do another phone call before we finish our scam at you. Good, go. What? Harrington, what? He's on? I hate you. Realize Podcast, you're on the air. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Yo, can you hear me?
What up, son?
Sup, doggy?
What's up,
I wanted to ask if Tom Myers has any crypto-Nazi followers.
All right, sweet. Thank you. Good question.
Wait, can you define crypto-Nazi?
Like they're fans of Tales from the Crypt, and they're also in the Hitler Youth part-time. Is that what he means?
That's me. Dude. You're talking about me.
That was actually a good joke. Tom actually nailed the fucking solid
joke. But the guy who called earlier talking about 109 clubs he was kicked out of was referring, you know, Jews kicked out of 109 countries, you know, stuff like that. You see a lot of that in the CumTown fans. I wonder if Tom Myers had something like that.
Okay. Yeah, dude.
I totally missed that.
What was the question?
I literally thought Tom was kicked out of 109 clubs.
I don't even know what happened. I had no idea what was going on there, but I like the fact that they are engaged.
And engaged.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. So, Tom, whatever his question was, go ahead.
The Holocaust, Tom. Yes or no?
Time for another good idea, bad idea, Tom. What do we think?
That was the original scam.
Getting kicked out of 109 clubs, bad idea.
Okay. Oh, 109 countries. I get it. Interesting. I should have thought that. All right.
Crypto-Nazis. Oh, I get it.
Jews
were kicked out of 109 countries.
Interesting.
Yeah. And then he just admitted he's been kicked out of a bunch of clubs for no reason.
Right. He just came out with that. He's like, yeah, 5 clubs have told me to leave.
Also, I'm very bad at crowd work.
He's like, 5 clubs have said not to come back.
They didn't even know that. They had no
He's
idea.
Like, and that's not a Talmudic conspiracy. It's literally just five managers said, don't ever show your
there
face.
There are seven clubs in the greater
if you come
Baltimore
back
area.
To Zanies, we will call the police.
That is one of the funniest things I've ever heard. All right, let's get these scams before we wrap this one up, Shannon. Give me three good ones. Three fucking solid scams. I want to give away a t-shirt today.
All right, I'm really trying here. This one's from Patrick. This is a little scam. I work at Whole Foods, and we have a policy that we can sample items to customers for free if the item is less than $20. Sorry. So people can try a product, good customer service, whatever. At my store, all we do is mark a line through the barcode and sign our name. Sometimes I write sample on the item, too. So the scam is, instead of Lewis putting a naked juice under his arm, just take a Sharpie, put a line through the barcode, and scribble the name of a random employee. At the checkout, the item shouldn't ring up, and if the cashier does see the signature, they'll void the item and give it to you for free, especially at a big Whole Foods like the one in New York City.
So in what case would they be voiding out a customer's
Because
thing?
It seems as if it was given to them by an employee. Because our employees can put a line through something to give to a customer.
I feel like that's a big risk. I don't think that's going to work. I feel like you get a lazy employee, fine, that'll work. But I feel like that's going to have probably a 50% success ratio at best. Don't love it.
You are in a pedantic mood today. You know that?
Don't you use words I don't know what they are. Shannon.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Okay, this is
not a good scam.
This is from Mike.
It's bad.
I heard a scam on the show recently about creating a gift registry and trying to get a few free items from this store. And I have one that's more guaranteed to work. My fiance and I are getting married in August, and we have a gift registry with Bed Bath & Beyond. It's free to set up registry, and they have an option for you to buy any of the items that weren't purchased by guests for 20% off after the date of the event.
Ooh.
So an easy scam is to make the registry for a fake event, set the event a few days away so you don't have to wait a long time. Then once the date comes, you get 20% off whatever
automatically
you want.
Off of everything.
Yep.
Ooh, that's a fucking good scam right there. That is saving a dollar for every $5. You got to forget the 20% off doesn't sound great until you start to break it down to dollars and cents. You know?
So what was this again? It was...
So you with Bed Bath & Beyond, their registry is whatever isn't purchased off your registry by friends and family members, they will offer it to you for 20% off after the event's over.
Not a bad move, but it's a very specific group of people. It's got to be people getting married.
No.
Oh, no?
You can just say you're getting married.
Good point.
So when you do your big, like I just did a big Target fucking shopping trip, like a fucking loser.
Why?
Groceries.
No, I don't do groceries at Target. I do like house goods, household goods. So it'll be like shaving cream and razors and fucking garbage bags. And
I use Dollar Shave Club.
Do you?
You should.
Yeah.
Super cheap.
They're not my sponsors anymore. I don't fucking use people. I will not use products unless they're my sponsors. I would rather go to the big, I'd give it to the man instead.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's not a bad scam. I liked it. It's not bad. Shannon, give me another one. Give me something else.
Here's the last one. Maybe not great. This is from James. So my scam is a family-friendly scam, Disneyland scam. Download the Disney...
This is for my son.
Download the Disney app.
He's got to get two Disney trips for free. Have your mom start dating a black guy.
At Epcot.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Download the Disney app while at the park.
I'm going to Disneyland, by the way, Disney World, July 4th weekend with my son for the first time. And I'm also doing another vacation like 2 weeks before that.
So it's going to be a very crowded weekend.
It's going to be crazy. Go ahead.
Well, at the park, the app will tell you every time a ride is broken down. Make a note of the time. Once the ride comes back into action, you just go to the attendant and say, I was in line, insert time o'clock when it broke down. And the person working in line said, if I come back later, I could jump to the front of the line. Disney staff turns over so often during the day, they will always let you through.
I don't believe that.
It says not every ride breaks
that's
down.
That's not true.
But a lot of rides break down. You can repeat
that's,
the scam.
That will not,
it's a terrible
not
scam.
Let,
it's also, who cares?
That.
Yeah, that's
who
your
cares?
Fucking scam.
Dude, they will not let you. I guarantee
so you can
they
go
won't
on
let you do
two
that.
Rides. For the entire week that that happened to break right. down, you
the get big rides don't really break. I don't
fast
think.
Pass
Maybe
for
I'm
two
wrong.
Shitty fucking rides. Suck yeah. a dick. That guy wants to stop listening to the show.
Yeah,
he's no longer allowed.
Plus,
to
Plus, you
fan.
Have to pay to get into Disneyland, so yeah. which is an exorbitant amount. So you're not really saving the point of the.
If
segment
you had a
to
child,
save money.
Tom, do you ever want to have a child?
I can barely take care of a plant, so no, I would not. If I can't take care of a plant, then no, I would not want to take care of a younger version of me.
I don't understand, though, but a child, the plant and a child are different.
The plant doesn't need as much care and attention.
The child needs more care.
The child
plant.
Needs more
so
care.
So it would be
yeah.
harder.
What about, like, have you ever thought maybe getting an egg, like in high school where they have you take care of an egg for a couple weeks to see if you wouldn't break the egg? And then...
I would probably get hungry and then scramble the damn thing after.
So you shouldn't have a child.
Right, I shouldn't. Yeah.
Yeah, I understand. No, we'll find calls? Out a lot about Tom Myers. No, we're good. We'll wrap all this right. one up. We gotta do Legion of Skanks next.
Is there a winner? Do you want that guy to win?
Yeah, I guess give it to the 20% guy. You have to give it to somebody, right? Sometimes
somebody's got to get it.
Yeah, okay. That was a good scam. The 20% off of an entire order at Bed Bath Beyond. If you're purchasing, you know, things for your household, you're purchasing a new.
Yeah, if you move into a new house, new apartment.
Yeah,
you it's schedule a really a wedding for right before it.
Yeah, it's fucking incredible. That's also a good scam.
Harrington saying he has two calls with scams.
Two calls with scams.
Yeah, let's all do right, that.
Okay, go. Calls with scams, and then we'll wrap this one up. Good. What's your name? Where are you calling from? Put them through. Harrington now. Put them through. Put them through. I hate him.
He's retarded.
What, Harrington? What?
You're embarrassing us in front of Tom Myers.
What's your name? Where are you calling from? There he is. Hello.
Hey.
What's up, doggy?
Well, what's good, dog?
Good. What's your scam, buddy?
All right. So what you do is you got to order ahead from Panera. And then after you get your meal, you save your receipt and then just call the complaint hotline and say that they forgot to. They'll mail you a coupon for a free meal. No problem.
You forgot the what?
You order ahead from Panera
and you say they forgot.
Yeah,
the
like
what?
From Panera. Oh, so like you order a salad with chicken and just tell them that they forgot the chicken when you got home.
So yeah. if you get head in Panera, I don't understand what this caller's saying.
You got it.
No, you got it, Tom. That's okay, what it is.
Yeah. So I get it. So yeah, Panera Bread, basically if you call corporate and say, hey, they fucked up my order, their policy is just send this guy a coupon, no questions asked. They're not going to go and check it out. That's not bad.
It's not bad.
They don't even think twice.
We got to think bigger.
Yeah, but, you know, in that case...
What if I go to Panera and put a gun in the woman's mouth who's working behind the register and say, give me your fucking... You know, we got to think bigger.
Yeah. What about, could you technically just go to Panera, grab any receipt, and then call, and then just start a chain of free lunch, and then every time you go in, grab another receipt off the floor out of the garbage and just have free lunch at Panera Bread, you know, 2-3 times a week? That's a fucking... You're getting a little bit... You know, it's got to add up. All right, thank you for the call.
Oh, shit, that's solid.
I know. See, I'm making it better. I'm making it better by the minute. That's what I do. We have another caller with another scam.
I love that Lewis heard that scam and went, how can I also go through the garbage?
Is there another scam? Is that what it is? Because we got to wrap this one up. I got another show coming in. Do you think I'm lying about this? Son of a bitches.
He's grabbing it.
God, I hate Hampton. I was supposed to be in charge of the sound effects today, too, and let me not even get into it. Go ahead, go. What's up, dude? What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Lewis.
What up, bitch?
What's going on, man? So you said you're going to Orlando to Disney World soon, huh?
Yeah.
So if you are you driving or flying?
Flying. I'm not a fucking savage.
Yeah, fuck driving. But yeah, if you come up to St. Augustine, I can help you scam that Jew. I have an entire list of the attractions here in St. Augustine.
What?
If you want to come up, like, you know, I can get you into all of them for free. Can so me,
what's
you know,
a, what's an attraction,
Jew, man? I got you.
What's an attraction in St. Augustine?
An attraction, dog. We're the oldest town.
There's
in
There's a retarded woman that'll
country.
Call you the N-word.
Yeah, she was this guy, about this guy, history, bro. Come
this,
on,
this sir. Have you ever you on a trip to St. Augustine? That's
sir,
a scam.
Have you ever looked at a map of Florida? St. Augustine up here.
No, I've never lived
Orlando
in the state of
down there.
I have no idea what it looks
dude,
like.
Dude, Tom Myers just took a shit in
yeah,
your
dude.
Mouth.
How did that feel?
How did that feel?
How are you gonna ever be able to fuck your girlfriend again after Tom Myers just smashed you down like a fucking?
Every time you're fucking her, Tom Myers is really fucking.
Dude, you're gonna get an
man,
asshole
I'm
transplant.
I'm from Maryland, so I'd be honored if Tom Myers smashed my girlfriend.
Dude, would you fuck this guy's
would you
girlfriend?
Fuck this guy's
you haven't
girlfriend?
Fucked Tom. Since 2012, Tom. He will let you fuck his girlfriend.
This is pretty his,
actually, his girl, your girlfriend, told me that you were getting ready to call in, and so she asked me to mess with you.
Oh, he knows your shit!
End the show. It's too big of a laugh. We can't end it.
Oh, Tom, don't end the show, bro. I just got on.
You
come
got
on.
Would you seriously let Tom have sex with your girlfriend?
She just cheated on me, so yeah, definitely. And honestly, I was gonna ask Tom. I was
how do you think she told me about that he was calling in?
Oh!
Who did she cheat on you with?
A large black man.
No.
Who has a bigger penis than me.
No, she cheated on you with a black guy?
Zack already hates this guy now.
Oh,
how big are you? How many inches are you?
Yeah, but it's not even me, and it hurts.
How big is your penis?
I'm a casual six, man.
Okay, but the black guy had a lot better.
No, dude. Honestly, apparently he was a casual six, too. I was there watching.
Oh, so you're cocked.
He's being cocked. I got it.
We got it.
All right, dude. Thank you for calling, my brother.
No, I wasn't there watching. I'm ashamed. But that being said, now that I hear Tom Myers is a massive 6'3", I might have to jump in on that trend.
Hell yeah, dude.
You know what I mean?
Tom Myers is just a built like a brick shit house. Well, you guys can't see it on camera because you know the camera takes away 30 or 40 pounds, they say.
And muscle and frame.
But he's fucking
enamel
like,
in your teeth.
Doggy, this guy is a fucking built like a brick shit
house. Hey, Tommy boy.
Yes.
You're looking mighty fine, brother. You look better than Steve Buscemi, so you're killing it.
Oh, hell yeah.
That's it, man. Thank
that's
you
the,
very
that's
much.
The,
also, yo, Lewis,
that's the best compliment I've had all week.
Come down to Florida. I'll be there, man.
Thanks, man. I appreciate the call. Thank you so much for listening. All right, we got to wrap this one up.
He is going down to Florida. He said it like five times already today. He is going down.
Fuck this guy, Tom. I'm with you, man. Fuck this guy. That fucking doesn't know how to call. Doesn't even know how to ask a fucking proper question. Doggy. Thank you so much, Tom, for coming to the show.
Well, thanks for having me on.
Very fucking hardcore, very badass, very real ass.
Yeah.
Really gave it to Nick Mullen and team CumTown.
Really swung his cock around.
Yeah, well, you're welcome to come back on the show whenever you want to come in. I know you came in from Maryland specifically, but hopefully we'll be back on soon.
Where can people find you and your podcast, Politipod?
We have a SoundCloud page, and the link to Politipod is on tommyers.us.
Beautiful. All right, guys, thank you so much for listening to the Real Ass Podcast. We will be back on Friday with another two white guests. Goodbye.